If Roy is on the blue side, he is the Lord Commander.
Which one of you guys want to do? Because everybody else is pretty much going to... If you get human, then everybody else is on the other side.
Human.
So, you're human.
You're Lord Commander.
And we're over there.
Hey, we're over there.
So,
hey, thanks, guys.
So you three are over here.
Perfect. You want bird?
Great.
Then us three are over here. You want
get,
bird?
I can't get to
yeah, I'll take bird.
Okay. So.
Do you want to be commander or control?
No. Ryan's commander.
Alright.
Ryan's commander.
Uh-huh. Do you actually want to be?
No,
he doesn't want to
he's
do
actually
it. No, he's going to do it. He's going to do it.
Okay.
Oh,
you've
man,
got,
he has
you've got the meta chair.
On that side.
Commander's chair.
Look at that. He has like a whole...
There's less people over there. There's five
yeah,
units.
They're
tier
more
seven
colorful.
Units. Okay, they're painted.
Oh,
<'cause laughs> these are from the...
Bro, get to work.
I'm sorry,
man. Demand mine to be painted.
You have... You guys have the expansion guys, and then these guys have the basic
OG
guys.
Also,
and then I have
bird,
like,
take
some
off
of both.
We're out.
And he has some of both.
As the commander, I want the two big guys in the middle.
Okay.
Got it.
So here's this.
This looks awesome.
We're going to leave them on their setup. So what I was going to say is with these, you can decide whether to put it on this space or this space, whichever one you want to try to protect more.
On both sides.
Say what?
What a poopy. I got them.
But if your opponent gets to this, if they get to that space, then they get two points. So
if they control it or just get into
it.
Are we taking the point? TF2 rules?
But these are...
I'm not sure if we should put it
that game
here
I played for a while before I played Dota.
Maybe over here.
That game I played
semi-professionally
for a while.
There's units over there, too. So.
Okay.
That game that I don't like to talk about that just got upgraded.
Democracy is so cool.
Okay. You're the boss, man.
Well, this is just a place that we're going to have to defend.
Go
into
those guys.
So.
This is what I feel like whenever I try to ask an LOD for like help.
I'll put it over here.
You get too
okay
much pressure.
So, hey, can I get your help, please?
So we're going to play to...
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, everyone.
We're going to play to 15 points, unless it just seems like 15 was just way too easy
Storm's
to get to.
Brewing.
And which it might be. Then we'll play to more, but I just don't want to like have a super high point range 50. And then be like, well, we're playing
points
it all night.
50.
But the way it works is there are command cards that we both draw from the same deck. So each of us get 5 command cards. And the way, let me just show you guys like what these look like. So most command cards have... These guys are not paying attention.
I am paying attention.
It's fine. Hey, you guys are great. You guys are paying attention. Well, this guy's not.
He already knows how to play.
So
I'm watching it on there. Overhead view.
Command cards. So basically, if I played this, I would get 2 command... I would give you 2 units to command. So on in this area, so... From the line, this line here over, you control both these 2 areas.
Mm-hmm.
You get up to 2 people to command, and then there'd be 1 in the middle.
In the middle.
And then there's other ones that have like just 2 in the middle and 2 on each side, a bunch of different stuff like that. And then there's certain ones with special abilities. The way this works is there's going to be 3 that are out in like a common pool for anyone to use, and we're going to play 2 of these each turn since we're playing Epic Battlelore. So you're allowed to play 1 from your hand, where we each get 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then there are 3 that we're just going to put up face up over here.
Let me know when
so
you play.
So 1, 2,
playing it.
3.
Right at the beginning.
So
I get all the cool stuff.
Then there's 3 there.
Cool.
So these are your regular command cards. The ones that have like pictures on them are tactics cards. So on your turn, you can play a command card from your hand and a command card from the common pool here. Or you can play 1 tactic from your hand or 1 tactic from here. Any of the tactics that have like a number of units, you get to add 2 to that. So this says order 3 units that are not weak. So holy smokes.
All the soldiers.
That's a bunch of chips. How many snacks are out there now? Way too many?
Actually.
Yeah, it's fine. No, it's fine.
What was I gonna say? But you get to...
Fuck your body, just get it out.
Like, if it was my turn, I could play a command card and then play, like, one of these, so that way I could give out commands across all boards. So, like, this one gives 1 to each, so you get to command one guy, I get to command one guy, and you get to command one guy. The guys that are on the red lines can be commanded by either side, so I could command this unit, or you could command this unit. The point of the game is to end up on these things. And if you end your turn on one of these, you get one of the victory point markers. So the first team to 15 wins the game. If you knock someone off and then they end their turn on it, then you're good. A bunch of the units have different rankings here. So the blue is their movement. So that's how many hexes they can move. So you have spaces. The red is the attack. So if they're adjacent to another unit, they can hit them, or certain people have range, like the Blood Sisters here, or like your guys there. The number there, that's how far they have that they can hit at a range. And then the green is how many hit points they have. So most units have a number of hit points equal to the number of people in that hex. So like this has 3 hit points, and when they die, you take them away. But the epic guys have more hit points than that. So this guy has like 5, and that guy has like 6 or whatever. So they actually have little markers they had to put on to show how many hits they've taken.
Okay.
For combat, for regular melee combat,
You
roll a dice equal to the number. Like these grotesque guys get 3 dice, and there's several different symbols.
Punches.
The lore, each time you roll lore, you get more lore tokens, which allows us to play sort of like the special magic cards that you get. Then attacks, one sword will hit on an attack if you're not weakened. That guy's Steven Robo Rally. So that will mean that they have to take 1 damage. Two swords is also an attack. You have to take 1 damage.
1 damage? Or?
1 damage. So okay. Swords is 1 damage, and 2 swords is 1 damage, and 1 sword is still 1 damage. But the thing is, if you have the 1 sword and you're weakened, which means that there's only 1 unit left, the swords don't do anything.
Okay.
There's sometimes cards that'll change that. Like you can play a card that says, hey, if you get 1 sword, it always counts as a hit, even if they're weakened, sort of thing.
What does the leader drop means?
The drop is how many hit points they have, and the green is always how many hit points they have. The drop means that you put counters on there to mark their hit points. So if they continue to take more, then you put it on there. So all the epic guys have more hit points. The rest of them, like if these guys take damage, you just take the things off of there.
He's got 6.
But your guy can fly like all over the board like crazy.
I won't fly.
Oh my god.
You'll walk.
Yeah.
You'll just get off the bird and just walk around.
Flying's too mainstream.
Did you see the crow that landed on the back of the eagle?
Yeah.
The eagle.
It was awesome. Just
he just sat there and was the eagle's gliding around.
That's so silly.
Crow's dead now.
What else is there? A lot of the units will have special abilities if you roll the crown symbol, and those will trigger in combat, and they can do all sorts of different things depending on the unit. So you'll basically just have to.
So that one also
it.
Has that symbol.
Yep, and then like the lore, the units that have like the lore, which are going to be just the units on this side, that means you have to spin the lore instead of just gaining 1 lore. You have to spin the lore dice to trigger that ability in combat. What was I going to say? There's also the retreat symbol, the flag. That makes the enemy unit move away that many spaces, which can also do damage. So, like, say you guys have a unit here, and these guys rolled a bunch of retreats. If they can't retreat across the water, which none of these guys can retreat across water, these would actually count as hits also.
Did they move that way?
Yep. You move directly away.
Oh, okay.
So with the water there, they wouldn't be able to move away at all, and it turns them into hits, which is good for you. But if they were here and you attack them this direction, they'd be able to retreat back this way.
Okay.
Whenever someone retreats, you can immediately advance into the space that they started their turn on. So, like, if you were here, you made them retreat, and then you could jump on that space. There's also counterattacks that happen in melee combat. So if they retreated here and you moved in, then they get to counterattack, and there's a lot of back and forth. But we can try to kind of go over that like as it happens.
Alright, team. No retreating. There's no honor in coward.
What is it?
Which one are these?
It's these guys over here. And we can just share this back and forth. Because those are like the basic unit for like this side over here.
Okay.
Keep me alive.
But the targeting symbols on these, that's for range combat.
Yeah.
So it's harder to hit people on range combat because it's just like 1 out of 6. So, and you roll however many dice that they have, a range of 1 to 3. They'd roll 3 of these, and to actually hit, they need to get target symbol. So that'd be 1 hit, 1 retreat, and 1 mask, which you could do whatever this is.
Does a retreat not affect range?
Retreat still affects range, so if they were standing here and couldn't retreat, they'd take damage, or if they were standing here, they actually have to run away and stuff like that.
Okay.
So, and then basically the way counterattacks work is if you're standing beside them after you've just attacked them, they basically get to just roll their attack straight back at you. So the people you attack are going to be attacking you back, unless you make them retreat a bunch, and then you could, like, move into their space.
And they take the losses first before they...
Yes.
Okay.
And if they're weakened at that point, it'd be harder for them to hit you. There are also these lore cards, which I guess me and Ryan are going to be worrying about more than anything since we're in the middle. But you start with two of these.
Ooh.
You start with two of these in your hand.
That's a good one.
Yes. At the end of each turn, after you gain the victory point, there's a lore step where you can either gain 2 lore, which are just the little things you spend because they all have a cost to play them, or you can gain 1 lore and 1 card, or you can gain 2 cards and discard 1 card.
Are both those tokens the same in both those little buckets?
No, these are victory point tokens.
Okay.
These are lore tokens.
Okay.
And then there's like hit point and weird status tokens and crap over there.
So you have 2 of these. I'm gonna.
Yeah,
two.
Move that off
there. I'm gonna.
Come back then.
You said 2, right?
Ooh, the house.
I think it's a 2.
The different terrain types.
Hey.
Don't flip it over. The different terrain types. The woods and the rocks you have to stop when you move on them, and also the same with the buildings. When you're standing on a rock, it makes you be able to see past one thing of impassable terrain. Like if you're shooting, like we put archers up here, and there were people here, we could see past that to be able to hit people there. The woods, if you're fighting someone that's in the woods or fighting out of the woods, you only roll 2 dice for combat on like attack and defense sort of thing. Like either way, like
is it -1 dice or 2 dice? Because this like only has 2.
Yeah, it's just going to be straight up 2 dice.
Okay.
Yep. So 2 dice is just the max in the woods. And then if you're standing in a building, basically the first hit that they do to you is negated when they try to attack you.
They hit the building.
Water you can't normally go across. The bridges you can walk across like they weren't even there. So you can almost just imagine that those 2 hexes aren't even there. But it still looks cool. And then the fords, you just have to stop on them when you go across them.
Get your ankles wet.
The only other thing is like the flying units can just fly over all this stuff and they don't care about the terrain sort of thing.
I'm walking, don't get excited.
This guy's sort of the same way. He can burrow and he doesn't worry about terrain when he moves.
Dude, we gotta eat that bun.
It's okay, I've got like rock horse.
Yeah, man.
It's really slow, but it shoots at people like crazy.
Yeah.
It's got a gun.
Yeah, the ballista on top.
It's basically a ballista, a giant ballista.
Where'd you get that?
Is that 2 to 6 range?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it shoots really far. Which kind of sense?
Fire,
but he can't shoot right next to him.
Right.
Wait, this
yeah,
is fire.
So he basically can't attack next to him at all. So if you get up on him, he's just not going to hit you.
This fire has hit stuff already.
Okay. Does anybody have any questions about their characters' abilities and things like that?
Snipper.
There's tons of abilities and things on those. We can pass this back and forth as you need it.
So you can cause the other team
okay.
to retreat.
So yeah, whenever you get flags. This is the guy that's the guy who's going to be telling you guys what to do.
So
and
I paid.
Let me just. It's movement, attack die, and health points?
Yes.
Okay.
See.
And health points should match the number of units there.
Except for the big guys, then they put little
6 of these. That'd be insane.
Yep, and if you only have 1 hit point left, you're weakened, and that means that the 1 swords don't cause hits in combat anymore.
Is there a cost to bring people back in, though?
Yeah.
Some of the lore cards could, like,
grass
heal people
eagle,
and stuff like that, depending on what happens.
So victory points are just 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the 2 on the side.
Yes.
The only?
There's also cards here that I do it, but you gain the victory points every single turn that you sit on them. So
okay.
Basically, you want to end your turn standing on these things.
I said, hey, man, bring a bottle of water.
And if you do that, you're going to get, like, if someone went first and moved, had a way to move all their guys on all four of them, you'd end the turn with four victory points.
Yep. I just needed him to beta test the cookie.
But then, of course, everybody's going to just jump on you like crazy. I guess to figure out which side goes first, because the whole side is going to go.
We'll roll for swords.
We'll roll for swords.
Yeah.
So whoever gets the most swords. So we got one sword.
Ichimon Tsurugi.
Hi.
I order you to roll.
Got it.
That's how this game's gonna work.
I got no
swords.
So
we go first.
Oh no, my honor.
Okay, so what we're gonna do here.
How are you to stop?
It's just weird. We're gonna do.
No Tsurugis.
We're gonna do all the movements.
Dude, Roy's
we're
going to
play advance the line from our hand.
In response.
And then from this side, we're going to play advance the line also.
Dude, leak that.
So we get two in each section. So you get to command two of your units. You get to command two of your units.
So this replaces?
Let's come to
an
agreement.
And that will come back up. And then this is the Discord.
Throw the game for $50.
One quick question. So this will be opposite for my side, right?
Yep.
Two on this side.
Mm-hmm.
You should just play it upside down.
You
so you can move too.
What do you want to see happen? What are these guys moving?
So two. I should not be thinking like Lord of the Rings where the big guys in the front and the small people in the back.
I mean, this guy's good, but he's very slow. Like, he hits really hard, but he's really slow. These guys are also really good, but they hit really slow. Your fast guys are going to be these guys. So you probably, since these guys can move three, you could probably move these guys like up to the victory point, but then they're just gonna be jumped on a lot. But we'll get a point.
So and then when my turn or when the round is over, we get the point.
Is something about Burger King?
We'll get the point like once we stop moving and attacking.
Okay.
We don't really have a whole lot of like range stuff. So if you have something that can move up as far as range goes,
I'm gonna blow the bird
these guys
out of the water.
So basically, the way it works is you pick which units you're going to command, and then after we've picked them all, then we go to movement step and you move them all. Then after you move them all, then you attack them all. So it's kind of weird. So I guess I'm going to move these guys, or I'm going to activate these guys, and then I'm going to activate.
I like how they do this. I think they have like a rubber pole.
So they're going towards that. I guess I could put some people
like
up there to support. What's these guys' speed?
So,
two? These guys are really good, so I might move these guys also. I might move them up
the
into
the
house.
Can I move through or not?
Or you do the strong attack, it's like...
You can't move through other
like
people, so it makes it kind of hard. So your guys that are in the front are kind of like...
Yeah.
Except,
no minion.
If you go into woods...
Do you activate those guys?
These archers are all BOP.
Well...
We're the mages.
I got
him. So
okay.
You can move in and
move
them all together?
Yeah.
So each
hex.
Where's
the
Lord?
Okay,
where's
the
Lord?
So
next
where's Hector?
Because yeah, this
like
one.
The red lines means that.
Yeah, the red lines means that either of us can command them.
Oh, okay.
Watch the
thing.
You
lose.
Yeah.
We lose.
So which one?
We're making fire.
Which one?
Don't worry about it.
No, we'll do this instead.
What's the crossing here?
What was that?
When you fight there,
you
so you have to stop if you go there.
And it doesn't cross water.
So you can't cross water. If you go here, you also have to stop.
And this guy's blocking me,
too. That guy only, yeah, you might want to activate that guy and just have him slowly start walking up there because it's going to take him forever.
Okay. So move.
So yeah, so first we activate all of them.
Mm-hmm.
Then we move all of them. Trevor's moved his. And then I will
move
mine. So these guys are going to move 1-2 into the building.
Oh. I don't think the innkeeper
and then these guys are going to move 3. So they're going to move 1-2-3.
They're going to get wrecked.
Yeah.
Huh?
Is that a plus?
Yeah, so if they're in the building, the first hit is negated against them.
What are you trying to, like... Oh, that's right, you get to kill these guys.
And then you get to move your guys.
What about this is also protection, though?
Yeah. This is a protection that
just
stopped over there, and then also when they're shooting
just,
from range, they can ignore, like, the first thing of blocking terrain. So if, like, there are bad guys here, and there are archers here, they can shoot across.
Technically.
So they house and
my guys out, and then
technically, I can only worry.
If they're hiding behind it, they would be, like, protected because archers try to shoot them.
But there's also attack
now. You can still move your guys over there.
It's only two dice, right?
Yeah, it's a max of two dice.
But once you move them over, then
so is it like if it's touching the line? So is it here? Either of us can control that.
No, it has to be on one that has both.
Gotcha.
Can you move through occupied squares of your own people?
No. You also can't shoot through occupied squares if you don't
play.
Okay. So not fire emblem. Not fire emblem anymore.
You can't. This is no friendly.
Can I convoy?
Yeah.
So now we do attacks. These guys have ranged anybody? No.
Yeah.
Right? Three. So one, two, three. No. But so we basically have no attacks because we're not adjacent because these are all adjacent guys. But we get 2 points, so we'll get a point for that and a point for that because we're sitting on them.
That's cheating, man.
A little bit.
You guys haven't even played.
That's kind of the way this game is.
Game over.
But we had to jump up there, so now we're just going to be sitting ducks to get like jumped on.
I feel like I'm well defended, dude.
And attack.
Good.
Am I not?
Yeah.
I guess
that's maybe.
That's what they were doing, but they weren't.
Yeah, they had a move step and attack.
And then.
Yeah.
Archers can attack twice.
And then we basically just go to our lore step.
Which is
where we can either get more lore card or get more lore, which we have no lore right now. Or we can draw. The way it works is you can either get two lore, or you can get a lore and a card, or you can get two cards and discard one of the cards that's in your hand overall. I think we're just gonna get two lore since we can't currently play anything.
No.
So we can actually like start to play something. That's the one.
Yeah.
And then we also refill our hand back up to 5 with command cards to draw one more. And then that's the end of our turn. So now it's you guys' turn. Yeah,
oh,
it includes going on.
Oops.
Definitely would pay a lot of attention while you were there.
We're kind of strategizing, man.
That's usually me.
This game, like, I'm part of a team, so
what's
I have to pay attention.
Those two, they allow you to move just...
So this one says, order 3 units that are not weak.
Okay.
So any of the ones with pictures, you can only play one of them, so you can't play, like, one from your hand and one of them. You can play either
other,
one from your hand.
One is moved to
but
the
any of the numbers
one.
On them...
Are those move 2 units in that section?
Yeah, so, like, both of these would move 2 units.
Oh, man, you got rookies.
I don't know.
No, if for them,
dude,
it would
still
be...
the yellow flag,
right.
Man.
Yes. Fun.
So basically, there's going to be a lot of movement going on over here if they choose to use one of those.
My morale's pretty low.
Also, Ryan, if you play one of the cards with pictures on them, you can only play one. But the number that's on there, you add 2 to it. It's like this one says order 3 units that are not weak. You would add 2 to that, so it'd be 5 units.
What
unit
isn't weak?
Would that one be like 85?
That means that they have more than 1 hit point.
Okay.
So everybody's not weak right now. So that would be 5 units anywhere on the board.
Do you remove these or not?
And then we can take
so this. with this though, with the 5, would it be 5 anywhere on the board or just 5 specifically?
That'd be 5 anywhere on the board.
Okay.
So that's most of the tactics cards aren't specific to like an area.
And then these
they'll
cards,
be like, hey, move all your archers or hey, move your elite guys.
Yeah,
or
let's do that.
And, like, there's a specific Battlelore card that lets you roll
it's
dice to see
much.
Who moves.
I mean, it's like
you get to roll 2 extra dice with that
one. You'll end up getting 7 and roll with that one. Yeah, so that would be 7, but this one, here you can move 5.
Hello?
Because you add 2 to it, so you would move 5. And then
yes, this is Roy.
After the move step, you would get to move an additional dice. So,
hey,
like, the thing is, we could start moving these
this
guys.
This is Roy's dad. Yeah.
Depending on which one. How much better can
you get 2 units?
Oh, good point. Fuck.
Look what
I'm
shitting.
So just this guy. Never mind. Fuck that.
We have one over here, too.
Fuck that.
That's these guys. See, I really wanted to move.
Yeah, fuck that noise.
No, you don't need to move that.
Yeah, fuck that
you
noise.
You don't need
what
to move that,
one?
Though.
Oh, that's kind of the last question that I had.
I'm super worried about Hector. Sweet strikes,
man.
Hey. Oh, he's gone. Okay.
All of a sudden, like, we're all...
Joe LaRock.
Dude, no, it's cool. It's cool. Like, what happened? We killed them.
You just come back and it's like, why is that guy over there?
So
on the rock,
like, play these cards, right? And
attack his life points directly.
That's like the last part of the turn, though. And I think they cost things.
Oh, the top.
Yeah, so we can't just be like, bruh, look at this.
Choose a friendly caster unit.
Okay, okay.
All enemies. Oh, dude.
I don't even be in
here. Lightning light.
It stuns everything around it.
Nice. I got mildly scared. I thought I was being brought into a drug deal at work the other day.
Dude, yeah, man.
By hand.
Do we lose her?
By hand.
Like,
we already
she was, she was hanging out. She was like hanging
huh?
out eating lunch.
They're doing something
easy
by hand.
She was like, hey, Matt, are you doing that? I'm like,
shenanigans going on.
Okay.
Like,
hey,
can you
come sit down?
Like, what order cards are you playing?
Well, real quick, I was just going to ask, do we get more of these at the end of the turn?
Yes. You get
go
two.
Back to five.
But you can't play two from your hand.
Mother F.
You have to play.
Oh.
You're only allowed to play one from your hand and one from here.
Where's
from?
Well.
And also, you're only allowed to play one period if it's the one with a picture on it.
No pictures.
What?
But you add two
guys?
To that. So,
oh.
Like, this would be five people on the board anywhere.
Only
yeah,
words.
That's how it was. Yeah. That's the closest we're going to get to original strategy.
Mm. So, two, and then one in the middle.
Jesus.
you should curse one. Okay, so basically you can use the little blue tokens to give let everybody know how many they have.
So dos, uno, two. And these I discard here.
Yep.
Curl.
The good things is if they don't kill us, we get to counterattack.
Well, yeah.
We're going to kill you.
That's the cards
well,
for
so
like a setup scenario.
So
we're playing
just
like a
I'm
going to
move
thing.
These guys.
Most of everything in there is going to be like for the two player.
That way. So I can see if I can attack his dudes.
You won't be able to because of the mountains.
If you
I guess
if
you
stood
one.
On
yeah.
the mountain.
Yeah.
Shoot over
can
the mountain.
I stand on a mountain and shoot over a mountain?
I think
can
so,
you shoot
yeah.
down from the mountain?
Okay.
Can I counter?
I'll just
toss
fireball. Fireballs over.
They have to be like a
so how
it
works
in
fireball?
It's a lot harder
range.
To hit with range attacks
range.
Most times.
Unless
too.
You're already ranged.
Unless
you're
ranged.
But it's that awesome.
You can't counter attack the ballista.
Yeah. So that can attack awesome.
Your girls are going to get shot at.
I know.
Okay.
That.
Well, what I'm trying to figure out is what I should awesome.
Hey, I picked mine.
People are going to die in this game. That's just the way it's going
to
be.
Wait, but, oh no, I wanted to do
the
entire
well, yeah,
you
don't
have to.
No,
oh, wait,
happen.
No, that they're already attacking.
I'm going to
okay.
do that.
Okay.
That's
okay.
We talked about you.
Shut up!
Oh, hey, Goofy Commander, can I get a rule in here? Would it be better to run these guys up and try to get a
it's
victory
It's your side,
point?
Dude.
we're not doing teamwork here.
It's your side.
He's
you better get me points.
He's only the commander who's telling me one.
Go in the mines, get gold, come back. Don't care.
Okay, so you put all your things there. Now
yes.
you move them, and you can do it in whatever order. Sometimes there are cards that we could have if we had enough lore to like be like, okay, now that you picked your units,
yeah.
we're going to play this card out. And it's going to put up some, like, weird terrain that makes
Hello.
It hard for you to move those guys. Or...
Zippity-doo. Holy, you just moved those guys.
I think these guys are going to get shafted.
Dude, why'd you do that? We got to get a point somehow. We're two ahead.
Across the table.
Okay.
So who else? Oh, you moved back.
You don't have to... you didn't move your token off. Or you did.
I
you could leave it on there because... They get a chance to attack.
Oh, that's
so now you can do attacks. So those guys are not going to be attacking,
oh,
right? Because they're not adjacent to anybody.
Nope.
It's only the people that were
activated. Yes.
Son of
only the people that are activated can attack.
You activated the wrong ones!
You activated my trap card!
Dang it!
These guys, are these guys attacking?
Yes.
What's their range?
Three.
Okay, cool. So
One
they should
three.
Be able to...
Yeah.
Since they're on the mountain, they can skip over this mountain and hit them here. So you roll, how many attacks do you get?
Three?
Where's all the dice?
Three
so you get three dice, and you have to get the actual targeting symbol on the die, so it's one out of six.
So no swords targeting.
It's no swords targeting.
No.
So the swords do nothing for you.
No tsurugi.
So there's some lore.
Sparkles?
What's,
I got all the sparkles.
Activate.
So basically, what lore does is gives you lore tokens.
Hey!
Probably
I gave you some sparkles.
Does he have like a chance to re-roll or something, or do we just that's just what we got?
That's just what you get if you unless you have something crazy.
No, it has.
Oh,
draw.
Oh, draw one card from your lore deck and gain a lore. Holy crap! Can I do that three times?
Yes, since it's that.
Draw game. Three lore cards.
And then you
and then gain three lore.
Anyway,
what's the max hand size for lore cards in there? I don't.
What's
I
lore?
It's those cards.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you gain three of these.
Perfect. That's awesome. No combat was had, but sparkles.
Sparkles.
It's fireworks.
It's like monsters. Yeah, man. Duke Devlin. I'm going to throw it. I'm not going to that soda can.
The only reason I knew about that is...
So you can't have more than 4 lore cards in your hand at the end of the lore step. So you need to keep those cards in your hand. But at the end of the lore step, you have to only have a max of 4.
So basically at the end of his turn.
You can spend the lore you just got on some of those. And it would discard down. Anyway.
Cool. Next.
You play ransack the Vatican.
Ryan, are these guys attacking?
Yes.
Okay.
Or who
are they attacking?
These lovely ladies.
So same thing, 3 dice.
So 3 dice, yeah.
Now should I spend that or should I wait and build up some more?
You don't have enough to use that.
Well, you're gonna have to discard 1.
I thought you didn't know how to count.
I'm saying, but
unless I'm sorry.
It still hasn't been proven that he knows how to count.
I'm gonna play take aim. So I'm gonna spend 2 of those fellows there. Play during my attack step after I declare an attack of a range, or declare a target of a range attack.
Okay.
I get to add 1 die, and then I may reroll each die once during the attack roll.
That sucks for the lady.
Fight!
And the other thing is, it's these guys too, so if you roll more sparkles, you can get more lore.
So what are shields?
So that's rune shield. Shield a friendly unit within 1 hex of this unit, and when the shielded unit is attacked, remove the shield marker from that unit's hex and ignore it.
Gives them an extra hit point.
So you could give one of these 2 guys a shield if you wanted to. But does that last until it goes away?
Probably just reroll.
Yep, because there's a token over here.
That's cocked.
I'm gonna just kill them all.
Hey, wait a minute.
There's the clear box on there.
Wait a minute.
We'll just sadly put them back in the box.
One more.
Don't worry, I'll get you some. I'll get you some more horse.
How long was that game?
I had archers?
Was that on the Sega Genesis?
Our
archers. It was like Battleship?
Okay.
But like,
they're pretty mediocre.
Their
archers are
it's like you would see across the battle and you're like, aim the guns, and then you like fire.
Sonic Spinball.
No. Not even close.
What was I going to say?
You know where you're on a boat, you're in war? Sonic?
Okay.
Sonic
these guys.
Generation?
Yeah, they're going to fight.
So how many did I get? 3 dice?
Yes.
Against who? Against these guys.
Against the Chiroptera.
Against the,
they're going to fight the water.
They're going to skip rocks on
actually,
the water.
Actually, yeah.
Down, and then
kick that. Roll the dice!
Right, okay, so 1 retreat, 1 hit,
sparkle,
and then 1 more.
Well, the sparkles are different for this thing. Sparkles
so you have to go here.
On the...
And take a hit.
And take a hit.
Yeah,
get another lore.
Dude, I got a whore. And then you can take that space, right,
man?
Because
oh, sweet.
Then you get wrecked back.
And then we get a counterattack right now.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah. If you move into the space beside me, you have to do a counterattack.
Do you want it? It's on you, man.
About the point?
Hey, man, we can take a point now.
Or we could just walk back on the point. There's that.
Yeah.
Take a point. Oh, that's right, because you get to roll. So you can just retreat. Oh, that's interesting. So could you just back and forth like that each time? Or is that like a special thing to your guys?
No, all the time. Counterattacks always happen in melee combat. If you attack someone who you're adjacent to...
So if you were to attack and you retreat, you force them back 1, so if you only got 1 retreat...
Retreats don't matter, so like if he stayed here, I wouldn't be able to attack him because we're no longer adjacent. But if he moves here, then I get to counterattack.
But what if... So on your
if I went back 2 and he moved 1,
happens now.
I wouldn't be able to counterattack him.
So, but what happens if
so
you guys counterattack and then you roll...
Make him roll, move back?
Yeah, just 1.
I wouldn't get to move into his space, because
okay,
I didn't finish
just
his attack, but you wouldn't
turn.
Be on the point.
Gotcha. Okay. Wait, what?
I really don't.
You don't have anything.
We'll pursue 1.
That's...
What's it do?
Instead of advance. That's moving?
Yeah,
that's moving.
Advancing is when you move into someone's place after you made them retreat.
Oh.
Right.
So you get to, move 1 space and attack again or something like that?
No, instead of moving, you can just...
Well,
yeah,
you can attack again.
Yeah.
What does it say?
Oh.
Pursue 1. Instead of using advance, this unit may move 1 hex and perform an additional attack.
Cool.
Oh.
I don't know what that spins. Does that spin the my sparkles right here?
Nah, because that doesn't have like a...
That just happens?
I think.
Yeah, so you move, and then you'll get to attack again, but we'll still get to counterattack.
That's fine.
Unless we die, which I'm pretty sure we'll be
dead. I fight.
So we can.
Two swords.
One hit. And I think you have a
one retreat.
And do you have a shield?
Are you my crown?
Yeah, like on the card.
No. You don't have any retreats. What do you mean causes one retreat?
No, the two
swords. Oh, he can use the two swords to cost one retreat instead of hitting me.
Oh, is that what that is?
So you can either do damage to them or you can make them go back.
That's two hits.
He can't kill them.
Oh.
No, it's one hit.
It's only
sorry.
One hit.
Sorry,
two swords is only always just one hit. One sword is always one hit unless you're weakened.
Yeah,
it's zero
okay.
hits.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
Okay. So now there's a attack back, and these guys have three dice, but they are weakened, which kind of sucks.
There's some flags as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's one hit and one lore.
Nothing with lore.
Huh?
Yeah.
Nothing with lore on those guys. So you take one damage on these guys. That goes away.
Murder!
Yeah. They're within range of.
Meh.
Please tell me the fat guys can throw up.
Sidon.
No,
they can't. But they can eat people if you get the right lore card, and they heal themselves when they do.
Jeez.
So now those guys.
They fight.
Oh, here we go. Now we get a lore, though.
So you get a lore.
What's the top part of that card?
This one?
Counterattack?
Yeah.
You can use two swords instead of hitting to cause a retreat.
Okay.
Yeah, they do get a counterattack. So.
Mm.
Make it happen.
Yes!
Yes!
That is so
good! And a response.
Do you have something to play in response? I mean, because there definitely are responses sometimes.
What is the order step?
The order step is, you know, right when we're placing all the tokens on the people, that's the order step.
Okay.
So you place all the tokens, which is the order step. Then the movement step is when you move them all, and the attack step is when
you
actually move them.
Lore, what you got, man?
No responses.
No responses.
Hey, man.
You guys die.
Our
I'm feeling
died.
Pretty okay
I
about
get
that.
Keep your jam.
Huh?
There's the blue box, or there's the actual game box over here. You can put all your dead units in there.
Dude, we got
so just hand all the dead units down to Matt.
All the same.
And just stack them in there. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I'll organize it all later.
Oh, yeah, we organize it now.
Okay.
All right.
So
everybody,
you
get
now you get points for all the victory points you're standing on. So you get two.
Yay! 2 points. Dos.
So one,
dos.
Two.
It's
2-2.
Dos
puntos,
way.
Hey!
Puntos,
no putos.
Puntos.
Okay.
I'm not good at diction.
Okay,
it's okay,
and then you have your lore step, which is where you can either take a card and a lore, or you can take two lore, or you can take... Yeah, you can fill your hand back. You just get one of those. A card and a lore, or you can take two lore... Or you can take two cards and you have to discard one.
It was
card.
Five, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
one and a lore.
No, you can just take two lore.
But you have to discard at that point.
Yeah, just take two lore and hold on.
I thought
you
said one and one.
You don't have to. You can take two lore.
And then you can take two
card
lore or one and one or two of these cards and then discard
just
one.
Get two
I just said I want one and one.
Well, then you're gonna have to discard a card.
They thought you said five was the
four
max.
Is the max.
Oh, I'll take two.
Why does he have two piles?
What do you mean?
One there.
Because that's a command cards and that's his lore cards.
Where are command cards?
There,
oh,
I have them
okay,
all the
okay,
same
okay.
pile. Okay, so now it's our turn.
These guys gonna get wrecked.
I'm just gonna freaking come in.
That's okay, man.
Just say it.
No!
There's a really good one over there.
No!
What do you want to do?
Just go middle like crazy. I don't even have that many people in the middle.
No.
That's too many.
You grab that one.
It's too many.
And then we grab mine on the side. And we'll just, yeah.
Blah,
yep.
Blah.
Yep.
Oh, it's business cards.
Hey, tiny pampers.
We don't have that many in the middle, though.
Yeah, but we can still move. These guys are slow.
Oh,
we can start
guys,
moving.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
all this
that.
Is the middle.
Yeah.
And there's
that,
two victory points in the middle, technically. So.
It's after.
Yeah. I think,
yeah.
You think I think we should do this because this has more points on it. And I don't want to just waste.
Yes.
Oh, actually, that's
so
much.
So we wait until they do the thing.
We'll do this one.
Yeah, because
you have a ton of people
over
here. I need three movements.
So when they do the thing,
that means that this guy's only
going
to have.
Nice.
Moves that
so
one guy
it looks
up.
Like
he's
they're
the spot.
Use
I guess you're right. You're doing
so
good over here.
Yeah. I mean, you can just move
that's
up.
Really advanced tactics.
We're going to play this.
No.
And this. So that means I get three. He gets three. And Hector gets one.
That is poopy.
I don't know what I do.
So poopy. So poopy.
Remember this one. This you add jacked. Two to this, so this would be just five people.
No. Do you add two to what's in your hand as well?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So if it's like three archers,
if
you
I
move
had some.
Five archers.
Gotcha.
If you have them.
If,
so,
if
I
had
them. Like ours is like, oh,
all
I
the
we
bugs
all the
move.
Archers. That doesn't do any good.
I might kill our
bugs on the move.
Say what? I might kill our bug.
I'm like over here terrified.
Why?
He's like, I might murder this thing.
Yeah. I need to avenge my blood seers. Or bug sisters.
Wait, you're gonna kill that crap?
I'm gonna go sit in the house with a bug.
Dude, that sounds awesome. Because it'll make it really hard to kill him, and he has like a bajillion hit points. And then he can just like burrow somewhere else. Like, if we, honestly,
I'm
gonna
those
guys
over and then.
You're not gonna move these guys into
no.
combat?
I can make these guys reach here, and
yeah,
I can have range combat with them.
But we have to be.
Why don't you?
Because I
don't want. These can't stand behind to get range.
I can go right to here.
Okay.
So next turn.
We'll just make sure these guys attack first, because
yeah.
if you attack these first and they retreat, then you can't advance in that
yeah.
space because it's
yep.
not melee.
Yep.
Okay. I'm going to order...
Whether you want to attack...
I can't.
Move these guys out of the way. And then these fat guys can move up to attack those guys.
Just move them into the trees.
So it's looking
right. Fat guys only can move.
So
they can move one space
no,
and then
move your...
This guy?
Keep him alive.
Yeah, but they get three attack, they only get two attack at that point.
Shh. Yep.
What lore cards do
they
have?
Hey, we forfeit.
There's some leader you are.
Quit.
New
game. New game, fight club.
In the
that
parking lot.
Could really push
right now.
Everything. Can you move a second time or just
I'll wait.
One? I'll be just go out there, you're just like shirtless, like.
just out there, just. Who's first?
Like strucking like a Tai Chi pose. You're just doing heavy breathing.
What would we need for that?
Rain's not even touching me at that point.
He just
like, goes
like
this.
This is
he wants to drop and be like,
too.
That'd be like if you want to move these guys.
So this, they get to attack.
Take that baby inside.
But if you selected these guys instead, then you could get them to
we should
that
probably
spot.
Figure out what we want to
leaving
do.
Those guys
on next turn. So we're not like, good fun.
One.
So,
I mean, we can't.
Instead, leave those guys in the house
and then get those guys there.
Yeah, but
there's
so much to attack.
Some of
they're not going to be in range to attack anybody
yes.
from there.
So we could do like, I could just not.
I should just want to send those guys on some sort of berserker.
So you can do that, and then
we should maybe save this for when we need the fat guy to get like
why?
In the combat.
Do you need the fat guys up there?
I'll take it.
Why not use the guys up to the
but
side?
You can
five
to
and they are good. They get to counter before they retreat.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they're
well,
good
I mean,
at like
the
holding
thing is
the ground.
If you're playing on these cards,
yeah.
this one.
So I kind of
yeah,
want to
works,
sit
yeah.
on that spot.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping to make those guys retreat and get on there.
Yeah,
honestly,
yeah,
I wish that all four places this turn.
We should.
If everything goes right. If we can roll retreats.
The only thing is I don't know if I should attack with them first without retreats.
That's a backup.
Because I don't know if I'll have enough to kill those guys with just one.
It's up to you.
They're gonna get four.
Okay, we're good.
Look, Dad, I just want to fight.
I'm not gonna play this card yet. I'm gonna save our stuff.
Dang
yeah,
it!
It'll be better like to do that when there's more units that
we
can actually attack.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the whole thing now is just to keep that
okay.
here.
Yeah, they just want to sit there.
Okay.
And they can't move anyway because we didn't order them. So you can move your guy first. So he gets to move one space.
Backwards. He goes the opposite way.
Activated trap card.
Yes. Okay. So I'm gonna move this guy. He's gonna move to. I could move around, which would be terrible because he'd die. But then if they had got
yeah,
retreats, they would just die.
Yeah.
But they're probably gonna die.
We can't retreat that one.
No, not.
They're just gonna move to.
I can
move
them around. They're gonna. It's either that if you want to keep them alive, put them in the trees, and then they can't. No one can attack into it. But they're weak.
Yeah.
Can pin a fly
to
a tree.
I'd move around.
Just wait
yeah.
till they're finished
just
with the whole thing.
Move around. Because
I don't think
that's Hector
says
move.
That
you're not
going to deal right now. But my side,
more guys there, right?
And your center point,
not really.
Right,
but I don't want them just straight.
Crazy.
I'll give them a target. They'll have to waste a turn going
there,
after.
No.
They will have to waste a turn
going
after.
Yep.
And they'll still get to attack, which will be fun.
Yeah.
They could end up on the points if these guys don't kill them or something. These guys are going to move. They only get to move one space, but they can move an additional space if they would end up next to an enemy unit. So then they'll move an additional space.
Ooh.
Because they are hungry.
We're staying on
the they're craving. Then these guys are going to move two.
Stay on the point.
One, two, here.
Not moving.
Mm. Oh, they're getting wrecked.
You don't want to just wreck those mages?
Stay on the point.
I don't want to run up beside Hector's all of his
rude gestures.
I want to get us a point.
Find the point. One, two, three.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a home.
And he's allowed to stay in there right
Hector's
now.
Hector's doing it again.
So, like, this big guy over here, he can't. The Chaos Lord cannot go into buildings because he's too big.
Yep.
Interesting.
I think
dude,
your boulder
cool
guy can't. Can he go into buildings?
Chaos Lord?
That
goes there.
What's my dad name? He Chaos Lord.
What's the name of the eagle?
Like
does it,
Rock Warrior.
Does it say on here? Because I don't.
Without the kill. It'll say on there. It's an ability called Massive. If it doesn't have the Massive ability,
yeah.
It's allowed to go into buildings.
Ooh.
Cool.
So there's a lot of going to this. Okay. So that was our guys. Now we're going to do attacks. So he does his attack, which is not anyone. Here,
no.
I think these guys are going to attack first.
Ryan, you please.
These guys are going
to attack. I'm
the commander. Did Ryan tell you?
He
did.
Not,
these guys get to roll
to?
Four dice.
Because
he did, actually. Ryan actually super failed.
we're fine.
So that's two hits.
It's you could have stopped him.
So those guys just die. But.
Thanks, Ryan.
That's okay.
You did this.
That's okay.
And then they'll advance, so they'll advance in that spot. Okay.
So then, my guy?
Yeah, because these guys are not attacking. These guys are not attacking because they no longer have anyone to attack, and then Bub guy gets to attack.
So is this mine or yours?
Oh. Either one.
Okay.
Two hits.
Holy smokes. Two hits against battle mages.
Return fire!
They didn't do that shield thing to anybody? These guys that got the shield
yeah.
thing. Who did they do it to? Did they do it to someone?
No.
You were
he re-rolled those.
Yeah.
He re-rolled it.
So then,
yeah, does that get counterattack?
He will totally counterattack. He
okay,
just gets his regular dice.
Whatever number that is.
Three regular dice, right?
Yeah, since he's in close combat, it actually hits on regular things, which is actually better for you, I'm sure.
Oh,
even
okay.
on weakened?
Weakened, he misses on the small swords.
Yeah, so just the
so
double swords.
It'll basically be the same thing as doing it, but he needs sword. He needs double swords instead of needing targets.
No.
But it's the same percentage.
And he'll get
chance.
There.
He did not get anything.
He did get a little sparkle.
You
got sparkle.
So you're going to get a lore and a card?
Go for it, man.
I guess so.
Yep.
You're about to need a five piece here.
I didn't kill the battle mage. So.
You didn't kill the battle mage.
Their house
doesn't protect anything, though.
Hey, well, I'll get that next turn.
Yeah.
The house does protect.
Absolutely.
He didn't take any hits. So he would need two hits to hit you anyway because you're in the house.
Yeah,
so.
My home. We call it a home.
He has five cards now, but that doesn't.
He doesn't have to discard now
until
the end of the lore phase.
Until his lore phase or yours?
Until the end of his lore phase.
Okie dokie.
We're going to mess it up.
That's okay. He'll do something.
Hopefully.
We'll have a good time.
Hopefully. Okie dokie. So.
Attackins?
Yeah, I'll do range.
Attack range
first.
The thing is, if you roll any flags, you're not going to be able to get on the point.
I know. But is a point worth. I'd rather try.
Yes.
Have those guys completely.
Hey man,
off
believe in the luck of the dice roll, man.
I guess.
What's
I guess
range?
Range is three.
You'll still be able to hit him if they retreat back one space because of these.
Okay.
Guys.
Okay. Yeah, I'll attack with these guys.
Always attack with the people that have a chance to move on there.
Which is why I'm like super grumped that it keeps coming up like AJ said.
Fine.
Oh wait, they killed him.
Yeah. Fine.
Killed him dead. Holy smokes! Is this a game?
What is it?
Alright, and
should have brought Smash Brothers.
Yeah.
Where
did they put their
I didn't
other
think. Should have just played Smash. Could have played Smash Brothers. Then I would have been like, is this a game?
And I would have tried to make him how to play it. That's okay.
Now we're going to make a comeback.
You
Ryan
just
made
a comeback
up.
Now.
It's okay.
And try.
Yep.
So we're going to take.
It later.
We're going to take 4 points on that turn.
And get some chips.
So.
Got 4
so I'm
going
to take the 5
Ryan,
and put back
it's your fault for putting me here. You're the only one I've played before.
We get another one of these cards back. And then, what do we want?
This is good, though.
Should be mad.
Do we want 1 and 1?
Should be mad.
So
we should get 1 and 1.
This guy's a bigger beard. Clearly a better tactician.
How many lords?
At least one Fire Emblem game. Better.
Yeah, one and one.
So you think that?
Yeah, one and one will be fine.
Dude, give me strats, man.
We don't have barely any lore cards. They have like a bajillion.
Yeah,
well,
I seriously think you should just do that.
Or maybe you should give him strats.
You'll give him five and give me two. Because you're not going to be able to give me
more.
I mean, unless you want to go 3-3.
That one's
yeah.
weird.
But the thing is, you can give him five.
Okay, look, we are done. So now you guys get to command.
That's not too bad.
It's good for like.
I mean, if you would have been able to put that guy in the tree instead,
he would have been able to come back to two.
I mean, but the thing is, that
well,
whole
you
the
have
board
to
is like.
Guys. Yeah, you just pull one off of like, this guy's
that's
never going to come out, right?
Just a thought.
Yeah.
And then that takes him out. Oh, no. I feel like there's more coming than just that, though.
Oh, Brian, you're not going to do anything, are you?
I put all gems to you.
You do, right?
How many do you have? Five?
Yeah.
What?
Well, your side's going to be rough over here, man.
They can't, I guess they
definitely need
to. You can't attack through, can you? Like.
You have to be adjacent to.
But he could force him back to that spot and then kill him out of it.
No.
How far did the golems move? Two spaces. There's some quick
hey,
little golem guys.
Question: this thing, can it shoot over these guys?
It can shoot over those guys, but it cannot shoot through the trees.
So, but I could still just hit there because it's four.
They have line of sight there anyway. They have line of sight there anyway.
Okay.
Because through the line right there.
Okay.
Yeah. If there was a guy here, it'd still be able to shoot him.
Another question.
Because that's their one of their abilities.
I have to activate him to attack.
Yes.
Right?
And
I can't.
Okay.
And that unit, if it moves, it can no longer attack.
That's why I'm.
Forget your plan.
Yep.
I'm just kidding.
Okay.
So basically,
forget
it sits
plan.
There and shoots people.
My plan's
okay.
better.
But it gets to roll a whole bunch of dice doing it.
And with this one, it has three movement, but do I have to move it three?
No, no.
Okay, cool. Okay, that's what I'm doing. Are we all squared away? Are you Lauren?
Okay. This guy moved
I'm
a bunch.
Lauren?
No. I'm just asking if you were in. Do you have anything, like lore cards that you're
I have no lore cards.
Okie dokie.
So now you guys may move.
You may get some guys dying over there, dude.
Or you can get incredibly lucky like last time.
So these guys are going to move one, two.
Find the bug!
Hopefully.
Now the bug deflect the one.
And that guy's not moving.
Damage.
Don't find the bug!
Okay.
Yeah, this guy's
these guys, where are they moving?
No, if it moves, it can't shoot. So it's going to shoot because
that guy's
it has
not
a range.
Did you say
Ryan?
That's right.
It's got like cross the board capability.
Those guys, wherever you want.
So that's why I'm hoping one of these days it's not going to be
wait,
white.
Oh,
it's
you
gonna
can
be
move.
Left.
Wait, what's that? Why am I standing on the big
That's the thing that if we get there, we get two victory points.
Oh.
Oh.
That's what this thing is also.
Gotcha. I'm not getting there.
Oh, but yeah.
This half of the board
no,
is
right.
pretty light compared to the
other one. Because you want to be next to the other guy?
Yeah, I
want to
be this
Ow.
Guy.
You want to be right next to me?
You know, I'm stunning, man. So stunning, you can't fight me, man.
But, I thought you were...
Yeah, well, yeah.
Yeah.
You good?
Yeah.
Straight up, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, dog.
Yeah.
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 Because then
These guys are going to stay right here.
Chill?
Yeah.
You want them to chill?
Yeah, I want them to chill.
You sure?
Yeah, man.
That dog survives.
Either way.
That dog survives.
I can fire two times.
So what happens if so like he attacks with the archers and scores a retreat because he can't retreat.
So if I hit him, he's dead.
Friendly units. If you're retreating into friendly units, you just don't take damage.
Okay.
If you're retreating into like something you can't retreat into, like if he was trying to retreat into the water, it would count as a hit instead.
Okay.
Or if they're retreating off the board.
Okay.
But they're currently supported by units here.
Gotcha.
So either take damage or retreat.
How far
does
the eagle?
Eagle. 33.
Anywhere once.
And then he gets to move two after his attacks.
Yeah.
So he
that's
flies all over.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's
worth
scary me guy.
The tree.
Well, at least the battle mages
yeah.
weren't activated, so they're not gonna attack you.
And the
no.
other thing is
right
you have tree in the way, so I can't.
Well, you can't move. I guess it would this is probably a better way of doing non legendary enemy units. Adjacent to this.
Oh, jeez. Okie dokie. Good to know.
Sorry.
That's fine.
I don't know what else you have on there. You want to change it? If you want to change it,
no, that's fine.
I figured you're just going to attack
flail?
And... They were... Yeah,
they were
they can still attack,
they could move
but they
there
can't
if you wanted to go after the point instead.
Shh, why are you helping him out?
Because he didn't know.
I mean,
it's
on
my
little card.
I don't
think that matters for what he's doing right now. You mean for
if you knew that
away?
He would be stuck there,
yeah,
essentially. Those guys cannot move away during the move step.
Oh yeah, I guess you're right.
I think
that's kind of
yeah.
So
what if I had a phenomenal turn like AJ and had five movement things? Like, since this guy only has one move, can I give him multiple things and be like, move?
No,
nope.
You can only order once.
Perfect. Tactician.
That isn't. He's not blocking range.
Not from where they're standing. No.
Even there.
But they did move a space, right?
Yeah.
Would they be blocking there as well? If the range is four?
For the range?
Is the range four?
One
oh,
four.
Shoot.
Yeah.
Why'd you say four? I said four. I've been saying four since the game started.
You know, they'd be good standing back there, which is probably what you want to
yeah,
do.
Yeah, man. What's your damage, dude?
I mean, unless you want to get them more into where they could claim objectives or something crazy. But
yeah.
Oh, great master and commander.
Oh, well, shoot.
Perfect. Okay, so.
This should be fun.
He has shared some battle wisdom with me. If these guys are next to this bug, they can't move.
They can't move?
Yeah, so I only move two to get here, so should I move, like, one over? Or just fight the one?
No, man, forget that bug.
Forget about the bug in
forget
house.
About the bug. Forget about the bug.
In his home.
I mean,
sometimes bugs are in houses. Well,
I'm just trying to figure out what you
shoot
want.
Over the
no, roof. You can't shoot over the trees.
A trained archer can pin a fly to a tree without killing him. An untrained archer can shoot his friend.
Because the house isn't a point, right? It's just a good little base of operation.
It's just going to be harder to hit the bug.
Yeah, basically it makes your first hit not count against him.
Wait, the building should like fall on the bug if you burrow underneath it? Because he ruined the foundation.
He just like rolled into it like, hello!
They had an in-ground under basement pool that he's actually
okay.
Chilling in.
Attack!
Right
just like rolls in through like the east wall.
Let's
like a whole half
let's
the
see
house.
See attacks to this
like,
side.
Hey, friends.
Matt, make attacks.
Okay, so I'm going to attack with these guys first.
Yes.
Yeah, with these guys first.
Okay.
So I need red ice. Grosses.
Oh my god, what is this?
One hit, one lore, and one crown. Did they have a crown ability?
Yeah, but it's during your turn, if this unit was not adjacent to a target unit at the start of your move step, cause one damage.
So it counts as another hit.
Yeah, sweet. Okay, so that's two damage.
No, wait, not adjacent.
No, not adjacent.
Right.
But it was
not
adjacent,
at
the
start
of
your
move
step.
Oh,
so
okay.
So basically, since they moved up on you, they charged you.
Ouch.
So that just does two damage.
That's zero retreats.
Yeah.
And they're not going to be able to take the point.
Yeah.
So we're good with that.
Okie dokie. And then this guy's going to attack, but this guy's going to attack... Okay, so
dude,
I'll call upon your wisdom again. Should I attack this thing? Or technically, I think I can hit
this. If you attack this thing, you only get to roll two dice because they're in the woods.
In the trees, man.
They're in the woods, man.
They're hiding in the trees, man.
And this, these are blocking those guys.
Four, five, six. I
yeah,
can hit these guys.
These are blocked. Line of sight.
No, they can see along the
really?
Line there. Yeah.
So I can
this
I can
line.
Hit
and,
these
and the thing and
what
the thing
is
that guy right there can shoot past people.
Oh.
That's just one of his abilities.
Okay.
He can shoot past people anyway.
Just
wait, this is line. This isn't blocking that straight down the line. If he couldn't shoot over people,
no. Like these guys, if they could shoot a bajillion lines,
no, I think you meant is these guys blocking the line of sight for these guys.
Yeah.
Characters never block line of sight for that thing.
Well yeah, but
if it was archers,
if it was archers,
magical
yes.
Archers of this,
yes,
that's what we're
not giant
okay,
archers.
So I'm
gonna
hit these
okay.
Things.
Ballista.
No.
Okay. So I get four.
Oh wait, do you guys get counterattack though with the?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, roll that.
Let's definitely roll that.
I mean, you guys don't, right?
Come on, retreat, right?
Holla.
Wait, they get to roll an extra die for everybody who's dead.
What?
So I mean, unless you read this.
Oh.
Should we not? Know
add one die
this?
For each combat roll performance. Yeah.
Okay.
So that'd be five dice, but they are weakened, so...
It cares about killing them if I make them retreat there, so...
All of a sudden, they have, like, a retreat eight, and it's like, well, that...
off the board!
Those guys just took off.
Two, one retreat. Frenzy causes one damage, remove one finger from this after combat. Yeah. It's fine.
So do you want to do one damage or nah?
Four.
You would kill
retreat.
Off your own unit, completely, which would be kind of...
Yeah.
I mean,
so
I don't think it matters.
What's
that much.
The retreat
it
do into the woods? Doesn't that cause something?
He'll be in the woods. I think if he had to retreat two, since you can only move one, he would take damage, but...
Do we still get these?
We definitely get those.
Okay. And I'm definitely moving.
Let me actually read my lore cards now that I have all the money.
Did that take damage going in the woods?
No, because only if like they tried to kick me out the other side.
That's crazy.
I should just keep him there, because that's just a free point next turn if he doesn't kill him with.
Did I take a damage?
No.
Okay, I just got pushed back one.
You got pushed back in your woods of safety.
Yeah, that guy also gets to roll 5 dice when he attacks, though, so if he doesn't die, it'll be awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. And I get to roll...
So Matt's probably going to try to kill him off.
4.
So are you still going to attack these guys, or do you
I'm still going to attack the guys in the back.
Because he rolled into the tree.
See these guys here, then?
Yes!
Okay.
Or, I mean, do you think
honestly, we don't even have to come. You need 0 command points, and you've done
no,
already.
No, I need one. I want to.
Because you want to kill all the battle mages.
The battle mages.
See, if you leave them there, we don't even have to command them.
I
hate
your indecisiveness.
Matt, why are you not in the middle?
They get a free point if it sits
it's
there.
It's AJ's fault.
Well, AJ was like, he's played it before. Clearly, he knows what he's doing. And Ryan's just like,
I mean, I'm pretty sure I lost both times we played. With the each side.
So
basically,
it's your side.
You can kill off my range support if you can, or you and I'll get a point next.
Okay,
turn
Matt. From this moment on, puppet government. Okay, so
what is that?
Ryan's in charge.
Which one? Which hand are you guys using?
Ryan's in charge.
So
this is what we call two bad decisions or bad choices. All right,
I die. So poll: attack the single guy or attack these folks?
Who's voting for single
who's,
guy?
Who's in favor of single guy? Okay, awesome single guy is.
In there.
Oh, it hurts. Super in there.
That's no hits whatsoever, and one retreat.
Are you talking about?
You have to roll this to hit on range.
Oh. Right. Well, I forced him to retreat.
Does Crown do anything for that guy?
It causes 1 damage to enemy units adjacent to me.
Oh weird.
Yeah. So I just stomp the ground a little bit.
So you have to retreat directly away, so either one of these two spaces.
Yeah, probably this one.
Yeah,
get him off the point. Get him off the point.
That means we at least have to command something.
Oh, wait, looks like we have the... Wait a minute.
I forgot
change
about
of,
that. That's,
change of play there.
That's very blue.
Well, thanks.
Yeah, it was very
blue. Well, hey, man. This side of the board is still super red, just in case you...
I guess you guys didn't pray to the RNG gods before you came.
Well,
my counterattack was
pretty
bad. Like, I had 5 dice that didn't do 1
these
damage,
guys.
Right?
Yeah.
So, like...
And you had a better chance to do damage than I did.
Can we choose which...
Well, no, I was
the same chance.
Can we choose
die?
Can we choose one of those first?
Because you had to get the double.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
I want to do Arctic or Arctic.
I thought they already did that.
If you can kill this on the first
attack, we can...
How did we go? All right, I'm going to try to shoot...
2 dice, right?
Yeah.
And you have to roll the target symbol.
I'll be honest, my whole strategy, I thought this was a nice plot of land. I was just going to take
that.
No matter what happened in the kingdom, I have a nice little river, fishing pond.
You can build a house right here. That'd be awesome.
I'd probably do this. Can I make some sort of like,
you don't move,
fish trap there?
Oh, yeah, you can put like a gazebo or something here. You can look out over the lake.
Yep. That's my plans were just to develop this for my people.
I have a 3rd dice.
I figured I'd get some sort of cultural
on me.
Big guys, really? I'm
pretty stoked about that.
No.
honestly, it's a bad situation for him. Period.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because
either way,
all right,
cool.
We'll
kill the cat.
Yeah.
Something bad is gonna happen.
So you're going toward the cat?
Yeah.
Keep cat. Keep.
That would be a hit.
And a lore.
And a lore. Hey.
I need to give you a 5.
I'm gonna play plunder, and whenever an enemy unit is eliminated, I gain 3 lore.
Oh, you gained 3 lore?
Yeah.
And you just gained 1?
Yeah.
Okay, so let me take one of these back then. Okay.
And knock that guy down.
And now I'm gonna pay 2, and whenever an enemy unit is eliminated...
On your opponent's side of the board. Wait, on your side of the board.
Yeah,
you're right. You're right. You did right.
I gained a victory point.
Cool, so... Here you go. Here is a victory
almost
point.
Almost forgot about that. Sorry.
That's fine. Making up what we can.
3-6.
Woo! Catching up.
Woo!
You didn't make us retreat? Okay, cool.
No, because we're
they attack the cat.
Oh, they attack the cat. Okay, because if they didn't attack the cat, that would be.
But they
really
he still has.
We would have got those
three more things
for sure.
Over there.
If we
over
here,
my goal is already locked
over there.
Going over in the woods. Dude, which one? I'm going for the archers.
To
the cats.
These cats. Yeah.
They are flesh ripper brutes.
Oh, cats.
They're like dogs more than cats.
It's a griffin without wings.
It's a flesh ripper brute.
Oh, there.
Well, there's a lore.
Get a lore.
Do we have
does lore when you once you get to 13 lore,
all the spells.
Well, at least you have the spells to cast.
Fair point.
Because those things can turn the game.
So how many times do you roll when you attack?
So what I'm trying to
do. Normally one, the archers, if they don't move, they get two attacks.
Retreat.
So that does nothing because they're supported.
Yeah, it's just flags, man.
They're supported because they're fighting people.
This is a dice game.
With its bird, guy riding on a bird.
I mean, one more dice.
Let me see what this bird does.
Can I see the archer? You can keep rolling.
They're actually awesome.
Yeah.
They get to attack
two
twice.
Well,
but that's four, and they can do it against multiple people. And they
does he have the sparkle power?
The point units. No, he has
So I did two swords.
No, that's two hits.
Two hits,
yeah.
And then after that, I'm going to go into a forest.
I got a little.
Yep, and another one. Hey, I need you to give me
five.
Four. I'll give you a five.
You can do five, but that proved the comment early in the game of math being a problem.
You get to roll, right?
Away. Yeah, you don't get to move until after the attack step. So he gets to roll the dice against the eagle. But you get one less die against the eagle because he's flying, right?
I just like that there's essentially a wizard on a bird.
And he's weakened, right?
Yeah, and so...
Yes. So only two?
Yeah.
Only two dice. That wouldn't be zero anything.
Okay. No.
Oh, double swords is hits. Yeah. That's one hit. So you get this.
Take
on
a little teardrop of blood, and then go back to the woods.
In those woods.
That essentially you have a wizard riding an eagle who could be throwing fireballs at people
or hammers.
And
we repelled all three of those.
And then these little jumping up in the air.
That'd be awesome because I have four hit points.
Exactly.
Got him.
And then I'm going to go on a rampage with the bug.
Nice!
If I can.
Okay.
Or just give me one.
What do we have for
you?
Alright, so then your guy's lore.
Hey, did you draw up on these? Oh, did we want to do lore since we have 11?
Did you do anything cool on my turn?
How many of these can you have in your hand?
Four.
It's always
five.
So you have to have five, and there's supposed to be three there.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Don't I get this? I get to draw one and...
So you can either...
You can get two, or you can draw one and get one, or you can draw two, and then you have to discard one out of your entire hand.
One and one.
Okay.
Ooh! Pop it.
Oh, man.
Pop it. I don't even know what it does.
Nah.
I don't care if it rats the board.
What are you doing?
So we just need to play the battle march, because that does five period across the board. Otherwise, we're going to get... This is four. With the five, we'll get to choose exactly which ones we want.
Yeah.
Oh, never mind.
That seems like the best
one.
I was thinking of something else.
But these cards are pretty mediocre. These cards are terrible for us.
Is this
one's
anytime?
Okay, but
what's that one do?
No,
it's really good if you have a bunch of weak guys.
One of our,
but
one,
you only get to play one.
Use, how,
but the issue is... you need,
but if we use that
we
one,
we
don't get to draw any cards.
Why don't we use the one that lets us do one... Yeah, this one.
We might just want to pick this
and
one.
And then
we
try to get
it,
those guys on that.
Five.
Game over, right?
I mean, we can either do
6 points, or six is 12.
Okay.
Well, it's 12.
But so that's five adjacent, so there's only one.
They give us
12.
Yeah, it depends.
Those guys can't move all the way up there.
I don't think
that these guys
come at us.
It just,
like,
gives them one extra movement.
Yeah, but then they can attack.
I don't feel like they'll come at us.
Yeah, but I won't be able to get someone on that
line and be like, that's cool, because it's easier for them to hold it.
Choose an ordered unit. So you have to order it for one, then you choose it. And then they get to roll extra dice, and then they hit. Basically, they get to do like a special
one. Only one gets to. All
right,
we can say that. For the
honestly,
next round. We can say that for the next round and probably
yeah.
get to that spot.
Mm-hmm. Because it's a
right, and that would be the end.
Oh, so that's why it's kind of like
right now we just hold the four.
Yeah, I think we do this.
Yeah,
Or
can we just play that card from there?
Yes, but this is the only thing that we play. So we get five. We get five to come in all together. So how do we want to do this? How many do you need, man?
I need one.
You just want one?
Unless you want me to do something with the.
You have the most units on the board.
Yeah, but I mean,
honestly,
I don't have any needs. I guess I can do.
I don't have any needs.
Like,
I can move. I can make these guys attack them.
And the only thing I need to do is just sit on here, right? With this guy. He only moves one space.
Yeah, but we probably want to start moving these guys up some because they're super slow. Or, like, move these guys because they're super fast. Like,
check
they can, move.
Well,
they can move, like, over to, like, this.
Yeah, I was
because
I'm asking you, you want to move this way?
Yeah.
Or want to
move
this way?
Move them to the left of that.
So, potentially
eagle there. Or they can move.
So, like...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that makes
sense. It's mostly what happens on that side.
Setting up lethal.
Last turn would have been a little bit more.
Should I? I don't think I should. If I attack these and then they call me to retreat on the counter,
we're not
going to have
the opportunity to because they're just going to
go
forward.
I'm going to move.
They attack me.
And when you're in the forest, you're
I'm
going to
move these guys up to like the building or something.
I
don't even know. How many? We're going to get 4 points this turn, right?
Yeah. You have a bajillion dudes, so you need at least twos. Two.
And then against the eagle,
you're going to move the bug too? We just need to get your guys
so
into combat because you have tons of people over here.
I was thinking about doing something.
Yeah, how many guys
or
do you want to
attack in here? If someone attacks you or you attack that.
So I'm just gonna
run
yeah,
it out.
So here's the thing.
Do you want
like
most of them?
Do I only get two dice going against those guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Take that.
So I don't know if you want to do that.
No, not that one, the one on the bottom.
The one on the bottom.
Top when you look at it.
I can do that if I wanted, but my bug was just hanging out.
Yeah. But do
I think
that,
I should
and
just,
that's the easy,
I think we
like,
just do this.
That's
maybe
what
that bug
game, otherwise we don't have a whole lot of options.
Do you want me to move these guys towards this
I mean,
also?
Or,
so we're,
that's there. This guy's
I mean, or
there.
We could do... we could do three...
I move these guys up to there.
That's
fine.
Well, that was six. Like, but we would get
three. Yeah, because I already have...
Oh,
I'll have three
so
units with
so you would get three, and I would get three, but then AJ would just get...
That one's fine.
Don't you just put it in the battle mage, man?
I mean, but...
It's a weekend. It's not
this can be one.
It's
not
gonna
do much.
It has range.
Yeah. So see, that's the thing. So you can do that, and then we can you can start to help me here with this.
Look, we're gonna have
because this is a problem.
We're gonna have 10 points.
Let me.
This half of the board is on fire.
Let me.
I want to move these guys.
Just already have
we gotta figure out how to get five.
I can only move this thing.
Yes.
That's it.
These guys are super good because they can just take
points.
One
carries
pretty good, but they only get to move one.
I would just... No, I would move...
So
your best strategy was AJ rolling bad.
I would move the big guys. Move the big guys. His...
Yeah, but they can move up
hold
one.
The
only
thing
on
the
next turn.
One,
they can always move two. Whenever they...
Okay.
Like, if he takes the
exactly.
space,
so,
then he can move onto it. So they might as well just stay, because they're only going to move one space if we activate them. They're not really going to do a whole lot.
So what... This one's going to be covered.
So...
Next round.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So
we need a whole...
Yeah.
That one's gonna
so
be okay. This one's gonna be okay.
Those chicks have range. Should you move them somewhere so they can shoot?
I mean, so essentially,
see, they're moving.
Oh, I see. So I don't have to.
What's
yeah, so
two?
You wouldn't necessarily have to order.
You can move
them
like
and
here,
move
and then they can go 1, 2, 3 and shoot those guys.
Like
four here.
Oh, they normally get three.
Order that one.
Yeah, but you know, we would just have to spend.
I could move them here,
and then that would be good.
I can.
That might be.
So then I could still be like,
that might be his prestige instantly.
I don't know.
Or
corner
technically,
corner.
Corner
to corner.
But then that's still fine.
It's probably,
sure.
It's probably right at the end of
the
page.
It's probably the best time to use it.
Yeah, you're right about
it'll
that.
It'll be sort
sure.
of the same. It's not the same as that. It would be the same
it's
as.
It's not
going to
be good now. Like, we need movement. They've got a lot of movement cards. We've just got to, like, oh, there's one.
I want to say, the line of sight one, I think it was there. I think the scenario
like that
was
the best thing
page.
We had is we had AJ with 5 last turn and AJ was
I think
like,
it's the
cabbage,
problem is I think
cabbage.
It's like this line where there's a thing
you aren't the greatest
no, trying to hit
bit.
This
I mean
it's okay man
fight me IRL man what do you want what do you want me to do
you got
oh,
some
it's
more
range.
Though, so
it's
good.
Done by
the
middle
line.
that's
what I told my brother we play a bunch of Smash and like
kill
like beat me like 5 times in a row I'm like dude let's just do it for real let's just fight right now.
I'm going to turn into Meta Knight real quick and get some wings, fly away.
I'm
sorry,
some
spinach.
Did you mean to put
he'll
these
he'll fight
you
mean
real?
To
I'm
like,
I
meant
to
put
the
okay.
forward.
Yeah. Because you have to stop on the forward. Because
this is the issue, is I'm getting, like, pushed this way, and they still haven't moved that.
Can you see the pros there? They can move a bit.
Yes, but you have to stop.
They can, but, I mean, what do you have over here? Is actually
I think that's it.
Tiny Babisa.
I'm just going to move...
so you're gonna start movement.
Okay.
You can just move people towards the objectives. I mean,
this dice roll is like axes.
I'm just gonna put him on there.
No, I'm gonna put these guys on. I'm gonna put him up there.
That's
why it's off of him, because we're gonna be like,
I'll move him right to here, and then he can't. He'd have to move the guys to here to attack it, or. But also, the other reason is.
You could always have people
that. The other reason is if you get to the five guys here and you get to retreat,
Then
this guy is clear.
Okay.
So they can retreat back. If he attacks me here.
No, I'm including. I'm going to go
retreat back.
Big guy.
And
I'm
going
to ignore these guys.
If it's your own people who are in the way behind
yeah.
you,
yeah.
you don't take
Let's
damage at all and you don't retreat.
You
so oh, because they're supported.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
Yeah. And then so. Well, okay,
so you have people
like
next to this where they are is actually a good thing because. Then if he's in like these spaces,
use them on
yeah.
this.
Yeah.
No,
these
so,
these guys
so,
here,
so,
so it makes it really hard
yeah,
for
yeah,
you guys to treat.
Yeah.
So we can take the point unless they
yeah.
kill it.
But it would be better to
which
use
is
it, like,
fine, but then
I'll
have guys all around
it.
Yeah, I wouldn't
pay
that.
These guys
seems good. Okay,
this one
moves
because it only moves.
You don't have anything to play after our movement, right? Or after our.
You're right. You should read this.
Because we're moving to movement phase now.
Oh yeah,
just did
order.
You're moving to movement.
That's the fact. That's our guys.
No, that's their guy.
That's
oh,
the fat dude.
Oh, I know that guy's name. Besides,
and so
super interesting.
So I would see. Well, here's what I would say. I would
say
close arms, right?
Just
right?
So
yeah.
Bad.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And then you can either you can try to bust them, and if not, you're still you can
well,
you might
hit
a board roll.
Can't hit the.
No, you can
really
hit the button.
No,
that's good.
Are we attacking anything this turn? No.
Not really.
Remember that
no
one time?
We're just moving. We don't even need to.
Fireball.
We just
want to
watch.
So the issue
is
these guys are going to move
two.
I think they're
going to
go into a building.
This turn.
Or should they support
like
these
they
guys?
They either go to the forest or they go to the bug. And
I
the
think they should support these guys.
So like,
yeah.
They're going to move here
so
to support these guys so either of us can command them.
And just sacrifice.
Yeah.
Because I mean, that might be just what has to be done.
And then these guys are going to move to here.
And then we'll have to move over here.
Yep.
These guys are going to move to here, so they'll be on the
line.
More so you can attack at either side.
That's a good statement.
And then you go.
Because we're killing. And then they're just going back on.
Yeah. Well, it's more because we
that's
kill some, and then they have one left
that.
Over, and then it like counters attacks, and it's like dead. And then
that's
like,
on our position.
A whole section here just gets wiped out.
Okay, do we have any attacks?
Nope.
Do
we have any arranged attacks?
I said a real thing. He's made nonsense noise.
1, 2, 3.
No.
Oh.
No range attacks. Because none of our people have range.
So,
4 points. Yep,
so my
ten.
Okay, cool. So we can hold on to that.
We're at 10.
So here's.
No, but that's
right. That draw.
This thing, right? You can take this one and move it.
Huh?
And what
I don't even know.
But okay, but so here's the thing. It's caster units. Your caster units are only going to be these guys. Does AJ have caster units?
What is that?
You
so
have caster units?
No, I just have range too. With bowmen.
So it's just these guys. So, I mean, what you could do
so
is
what?
You could move
five.
Here.
Yes.
No, here. And then you
could
send those guys in the
bottom. Honestly,
and
if we
wouldn't
if we get.
Hey!
If
right?
we don't lose any,
I mean, you could move here and you could
get
these
that.
Three.
Only,
yeah,
the only
thing
that's
I don't know. That's,
kill a bunch of
that's a question for the GM there.
I don't want to ask.
Not that way anyway.
But everyone, I mean,
we always get really good all of a sudden.
I mean, assuming though, I mean, we have the big guys and. What do we have for.
I mean, this is
good. What do we have for our movement for next?
Not a lot of good stuff. It's all like singles.
This is all we need.
Well, we can replace one. We have to play one from here, one from there.
Keep one.
Yeah, but
holy,
have,
oh my god!
We
can. Oh yeah.
We can do that for the bug.
So we're good.
We can do that for the bug.
What are you guys doing?
Oh, it's your turn, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
No, we're not
after
doing
my
it.
House bug.
You just quit.
Yeah. No, we're not doing anything to like stop you. We're just trying to plan our next turn ahead of time.
Yeah. So it's the command step. I drew another command card, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
No, you didn't have. You already had five.
Oh, yeah, I already had five because it both from there.
Yep.
So we're good. So command step, guys.
You want to try that?
I think it's a good option. Because that costs. Yeah, so that's doable.
What do you
that's doable.
Not me!
I think that's doable. Because we'll still have enough for that if we need it.
The bug
in
the
house. I think he's about to get wrecked.
The bug in the house.
If there's a bug inside of a house.
Honestly, I think they're probably just going to ignore him.
The bird in the tree.
And then he's going to like...
So yeah, right,
so let's play this, because we're inside of this room.
Yeah,
well,
okay,
that's
so
exactly
the question is, do you want to play this, or do you want to pick that one up and have another one? I say play that, and then we'll get another one in our hand.
Spin around, bird.
Yeah,
then they would have the opportunity to play that.
It is spinning.
So I'm going to counterattack your last card you played.
So just copy it?
Yeah. So you're going to have five moves. So you had...
I wanted three, if possible.
Yes. And then I'll take one.
I'll put it on the
archer. Oh, okay. So Matt's doing everything on that side of the door.
What happened here? A gem hunting? What is this?
I'm a maverick, and I don't want to do it.
Okay, well, hang on. Are you going to do...
Wait, is that it?
I'm just going to wizard.
Yeah.
Okay, but what are you going to do?
You're pretty good.
Are you going to do that, or are you just going to hold
on? I feel guilty.
I don't.
Okay.
I mean,
are you not doing
really
that?
Are you
not doing
that
cool guy thing?
No, we're doing the cool guy thing.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome.
Can I add units to these units and make a four unit?
No.
Praise! They've been reinforced. Can I pull them back to home base?
Yes.
What, really?
Well, you have to spin an action and then move them, and I don't think you want to do that.
Well, I mean, but like if I pull them back to home base, do they get reinforced like we're playing StarCraft?
No.
Okay.
But it also can't move.
Yeah. That's why I'm just like, well, that thing's there. Good on him.
Isn't it actually cool? We got a cookout the other day.
Yes, we're done with the order step.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Because what was that card? It's before.
Wait,
this
oh,
one.
Wait, hang on. We need to like guard this because that's in dog range. I think they move three.
Yes.
Yes.
What did you do?
I
see the issue. I mean, we can.
I guess
we can just say fuck AJ.
Yeah, I mean, is that you want to do that?
I mean, but the bird at least be able to kill some stuff.
You want to do that?
I mean, yeah, it'll kill some stuff. But
I can always just do it next time.
Then it just goes up against a giant hell beast.
It gets to fly away.
Yeah, it can just fly away later if you want it to.
Or we can prevent them from getting two victory points since they're like essentially five away from victory.
You want this marble? I don't want to play
and
anymore.
And the thing is, I don't know that we're going to... Here's
taking my bird and flying away.
Let's go.
So here's
we're
playing
Robo Rally.
Hey,
it's
on
for
a long time to be. Put the bad guys up.
It's coming home.
I'm so excited because on Board Game Geek, I have the highest upvoted bird picture on Board Game Geek and the highest upvoted picture.
Oh, yeah, so
nice.
Yeah.
I'm like,
and
there's a bunch
of
random,
but
like,
it's too bad.
Time for me to go paint a bird.
I don't know. It's whatever, man. It's up to you.
That works.
Hang on. So let me.
Hey, what if we did him?
Let's.
But they also weren't the very first ones to be on Board Game Geek that were painted. So
yeah, you can do that.
Makes me feel.
Two dice.
Yeah, I mean...
Wait a minute. Which...
Okay,
what card did you play for movement, though?
The five.
Oh, it was with the bird. You took it off the bird.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I mean...
Are you sure you want to
do it? Can do it.
Yeah.
They can do it anywhere. They can put them all on one side.
Oh.
They did the exact same thing we did last
time.
So,
here's the thing. If we don't block that, they win the game next turn.
We're blocking it.
I know, but, like...
We're not blocking it. I'm not moving on that point.
No, the thing is,
let's do the move.
Shoot
phase.
The bird.
Yeah, let's do the move.
Teamwork.
Phase. I'm gonna read this real quick. On three, one, two, two.
I
have a plan.
Next game.
Don't worry, guys. I'm gonna crit. It's gonna.
So
be
the question
fine.
Is: the question is, does this work for only one unit, or does it work for any unit that declares attacks?
Why is Matt not sitting in the middle? I'm just kidding.
Puppet government.
He knew all the action would be over
I
here.
Think it's just
all the action you declare.
A singular
target. Yes, I think so.
No, but what if I declare a singular target?
No, I think it's just that one round.
Okay.
Would be.
Okay.
Well, how much does it cost?
That's five.
Yeah. How good is it then, I guess?
It's,
I don't know.
It's nice.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Okay, so that's
yeah.
we've chosen.
I would just assume it was just like a three or under.
Yeah.
Alright,
so we chose our...
If first comes to shove,
we'll
ask Roy before
counters.
We do things.
So what?
We chose our stuff.
Okay, so now we're doing something, right?
No, it's after move.
Oh, yeah, we choose not to move then.
I play the card. Because that's after the move, so...
Right. Choose to leave everything under tap.
So
I'd be like, and now we win? Like, we don't even have to do anything.
Alright,
I had to abandon my homestead here.
Honestly, what you want to do is you want to get our people off of the victory points.
First? Okay, no. Nah. Yeah, let's do that then. So
they're probably losing.
Next to the bug.
I buttered your croissant.
And then these guys are going to go over here.
Bug.
And then that guy's just going to hang out.
Bug.
And then that thing's going to hang out, right?
That thing's hanging out. And that's moved.
Okay, that's the movement phase.
Wait, doesn't...
Okay, after the movement, leak, I guess, yeah, we need to play this.
Yes.
They do have a leap card, I think, in their deck. We're going to play this.
O-ring.
Because it's going to be these guys and these guys.
O-ring.
There's a lot of range, which kind of sucks. This only works for melee.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
fine. We can still do it, because it'll protect these guys more.
It'll protect both of them.
Drop a sword.
Protect both of them. We'll do it.
Two more lore.
So for six, you get one less die on all of your melee combats.
That's fine.
that's still okay, right?
I'm pretty sure.
Could you imagine if this game had
I don't think
they
could be fucked in any way, shape, or form. It might, though.
We'll find out when we're playing.
Okay.
What is it? And you do it like this, you go like...
What are you doing?
Just like...
Nothing.
No, we are doing something.
You move all of your things, now you need to attack.
Okay, so I'm going to attack with these guys on this guy first.
Okay.
We're not using that yet.
They get one less
die. Oh, wait, what about my casters?
That'd be pretty funny.
No.
Just traders, and this is not funny. It's like...
I forget about that.
Just under the felt.
If
that that's the same one.
Okay.
It's the same one.
You get one less.
Okay.
So you want to get two?
Yeah. I hate that.
Jeez.
I love it. Mess with guests.
That
time.
Would be crown is one hit, right?
One damage, yeah.
Okay. So one guy.
Yeah. And then this guy is going to hit.
Wait, counterattack.
Counterattack. So I actually get.
You get four?
There's one more.
No, it's two.
Berserker's two.
Does your thing count against you?
This time.
Probably not.
Oh, you can reroll one die.
Combat roll this unit.
1,000 cuts, damage to an enemy adjacent to this unit.
Yeah,
that's
but this one.
Your balance
is
out the window.
Combat
roll.
This is a combat roll.
Pretty good.
You can reroll one die.
So
that one's auto a hit. I think we should reroll that, yeah. That's
two hits.
To an adjacent unit. It doesn't even have to be that guy. That's the only guy.
That's
you can damage your own guys. Come on, man.
Yeah. Enemy units.
It does say enemy unit.
Well, that didn't work out.
Man, these horse dudes suck. This is not fireable. This is not fireable at all.
So, then this guy's going to attack those guys. So I need four dice.
Minus... Oh, no, it's range. Yeah.
It's range, so he gets all his dice.
Come on, let's go. Kill me.
I mean, a lot of targets.
That's okay. There's that 1 in 6 chance on 4 die to get 3.
No.
Suck all the dicks.
That's a crown. A crown or something.
Hey, the retreat means that we don't retreat because we're there.
Which I wanted to roll.
Wait, so you didn't get
to
roll any hits?
Nope.
No, man.
This guy hasn't done
a dice roll for you.
He had not moved. Didn't even get a house.
You just break it apart instead.
Let's just play that and kill the bug.
What?
What? Come
not
on,
the
man. We're gonna lose. Let's just do it.
I'm
pretty sure you're gonna lose.
On our rune blade.
Oh yeah,
rune blade
is real good. Rune blade is amazing.
So we roll four dice,
and
it can't be affected by modifiers or a terrain.
No,
four,
got
four dice.
And you get to like re-roll each one individually. You just have to save one each turn.
Yes.
Yeah.
What
still
they?
Not gonna kill the bug. The bug has 5 hit points.
Might be.
What? I thought.
Yeah.
I miscalculated.
That one's cocked.
Right, so do I have to retreat now?
No, we save one and then we get the reroll.
What was
that? Would I have to retreat though with a retreat flag?
Yeah, if he kept the retreat flag.
Yeah.
That's cocked.
Two. Wait.
Why don't you keep the you don't have to reroll them. You get to choose to reroll.
Oh.
That's fine.
Okie dokie.
Probably just screwed you because you had like a bajillion hits for each one of those crowns.
Yeah, but. I had a ton of charges. Oh well.
What's the charge do?
It just
does
damage.
It damage.
Oh.
It's okay.
No. So 3 damage?
Yep.
That's pretty good.
Well,
yeah, you have to save at least one each time, but you can save as many as you want.
And does it ignore the first hit?
No.
Oh, and it ignores the first hit.
Nope.
No, it doesn't.
Oh, because we're in
all terrain.
Oh,
okay. So it takes 3.
Poor bug.
Hey, counterattack, guys!
Oh, yeah, counterattack. 3.
No.
Yeah, nothing.
I'm pretty sure we've done more damage on counterattacks than anything else.
Dodge it!
Devour causes 1 damage if the target unit is infantry or cavalry.
So two hits.
Bloop. Two hits and a.
Bloop.
And a Laura.
Laura thing.
So you know what we should have done first? We roll should have better. Moved those guys and played an 8 for this time.
You can't say that!
You told me not to do it!
I asked you if you were gonna do it.
The only way you can roll better is if you roll with the punches better.
The thing is, though, the thing is,
I have no idea what I cheat.
Right? We don't, yeah. We don't know what that is. We don't know what it does. It doesn't clear
what
anything.
What do you mean, stun?
Yeah.
It basically means that
they can't do anything.
They have. I think you have to like spend lore.
You spend 2 lore.
You have to spend 2 lore to be able to make to order that unit at all.
Yeah.
And they don't get to counter attack or something like that.
They don't get to do anything.
It wouldn't have been that big a deal.
Yeah. Stun is awesome.
I don't know. Couldn't kill the bug. Couldn't clear those guys off.
Hey, these guys gonna attack these guys.
Okay.
Jelly Chiff.
Where's
they had range.
See.
Dude, there's two dice right, so you need...
What? Oh, jeez.
Really? Give me my winning dice. Sorry.
Use it, man.
Just go.
I don't know. I think it's...
Use the winning dice.
Just go.
Wait, how many do I get?
3.
I'm sorry.
A little bit of both.
Hector, you are doing so good, man. You are the best.
They're not even attacking you.
Honestly, like, you strike fear into their hearts. Oh.
Hey, you got one.
And a retreat.
One and a lore, so we can get a lore and a lore card. Come on, man.
Going.
Two different guys.
Is it like
2 points?
No.
One. You can only have one guy.
So you gotta take a hit, right?
God, no,
yes.
You have to retreat?
Yes. They're reinforced there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh,
really,
is it good?
Like, either way, you can't.
Is it amazing or is it just not able to be played at this point?
You want
to
do like,
melee attacks against
a
bug?
Huh? That's pretty good.
Is that what it's called?
It's something specifically about
that guy.
Oh, is it that one?
Oh, impeach. Yeah,
oh,
no.
You're right.
They
it's
impeach
those.
Never mind.
Huh?
I
thought it was this one. I was like,
hang.
Ron Quarter. Okay. I was like, this thing
is the roll same. Whatever you want.
Okay.
They move, so they only get one attack, right?
That's fine.
I'd attack the fat people.
It doesn't matter. Game's over.
Fat man!
You can't kill them.
Hey, what?
They don't have anything on the crowns, right?
That's that.
Nope.
But I do. Man. But I do shoot the fat man.
Oh, yeah.
Shut the fat man.
Don't worry, guys. We hung out for one more turn, assuming they don't have any lore cards that give them a victory point.
Assuming that your archers don't retreat off of that space.
Nope. Only death.
What did the fat guys do? Which
one? They can move. They can move. We can move both. Just
yeah.
Move all of these. Move both those guys up to kill those, and then move these guys
out. Yeah, good. Yeah. Well, we'll just take a left move.
I just didn't feel about my side board, man. It's not a
little
too hot, man.
It's
like.
At least you have movement on your side of the board. Half of my side of the board. Move one.
That one is a 3 minute.
Move one.
That's all.
Oh,
need.
The three
move
minutes.
One.
Oh yeah, you're just gonna do nothing.
I'm gonna order that.
I want vengeance, but
like,
not that.
No, you're gonna do this.
I'm gonna draw
yeah,
two.
There's,
and then
there's not ones
two.
That let us move
that's it,
all the sides.
You, are you really?
You draw
so.
Two and discard one.
So
yeah,
draw
that's
two
gonna
two
have three attack or two chops to get rid of those archers.
I see some
chat. And you have to move those other guys.
Not lose, but everything is on my side.
We just need those archers to retreat.
They won't.
No, but even if they, you're gonna have two chances to kill them off, or
they
damn kill.
They die.
There's
actually,
seven dice.
Not really.
Right.
They have to
I mean,
die.
If you can't, they can't retreat anyways. They're guard fire or whatever. They just have to kill them.
If we hit from this side and go that way,
I mean,
no retreats.
We got 9.
I don't think it matters if you don't kill. If you don't get 3 hits on them with those guys.
I mean, we've already got like all of this anyway. They're not going
to
knock us off every single one.
You have in your hand, the 4 is better than the 6 because you can't.
No, they have a bunch of those.
You can play a 5 and a 4, but not a 6 and a 5.
I mean, I could just play this bullcrap on those. That's right at the end of the move, or during the move step,
you know,
I get to roll 4 dice.
We have to see my other units.
What are you going
to
do? Pull a eagle
just
you
got 15 units on each side.
Is that next
one? We're blowing it.
No, it only moves one.
I still have 5.
Redo.
What the fridge?
Yeah,
redo.
But you get to immediately roll 4 dice.
Yeah, for
redo.
Redo
this. Redo it.
Right oh,
back.
You move.
That's
more.
The
game. That's what I was saying.
Oh, yeah, that's not good. We could do this.
It won't take an hour to set
it
up.
I don't even think we need to do anything.
Okay.
Why would it take an hour?
Does
it
pop
at
all?
No.
So that's our turn?
Yep.
That's it. You're right.
Unless you want to add another big guy for no reason.
There's no real reason to do that. I mean, I do. If the game was continuing to go, I probably would do that. Our turn?
Yep.
No, because you had to copy what we played this turn.
No, you could copy a counterattack which copied our counterattack which we played last turn. Which would copy the cover.
Unless five anywhere.
Or
I can attack with the bug?
Because counterattack and counterattack.
Do we want to do that?
You're copying the command card, not the...
But I don't know.
Not the
can we do that?
Card. So it would...
Play this card to copy your command card your opponent just played.
Yeah, you're copying
the
command
instructions.
Card.
Yeah, I don't think it works. I don't think you can counterattack a counterattack.
Dude, come on. That's basic,
that's
basic magic. What are you doing, man?
Okay, we're going to do this, which is three middle... I'm sorry, Trevor. Two over here. So...
I feel like
middle,
that.
What
you guys
want
to have a cookout or something?
Yeah, man.
Cook that
that's about all we can do.
I could move these guys and they could go attack and you could roll.
Cook that bug.
Nah, that's cool.
But we're definitely moving. Oh, I need to move all.
I need to
move
all
these
three.
Two. Well, he has to move that one.
You
still have one. You
want me to move this one so you can move
yes.
something else over there?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Swing move.
So what am I gonna do? This and I don't need to move those guys.
You can move
if you don't wrath
and then I get vengeance for the.
Jeez.
Yeah, but I don't need to move those guys.
Solid reset.
I
play dead judgment,
but I have an extra one because that's 1, 2, 3, 4.
Not playing
five.
That 2 turns ago.
No,
besides,
should play damnation.
We should have five.
Nice.
Five altogether.
I play
so here. Put
this
on one of those over there.
Was that was that old card that was like
Armageddon.
Honestly,
yeah.
Everything's dead.
No,
we
lions.
Could play
yeah.
the one card and let that guy move like across
or,
the freaking board.
Wrath of God, where it's just like everything
yeah.
is.
But the problem is they're all
dead.
Woods.
Yep.
Like
and
that's the problem
generate.
Is they're not gonna be able to hit very hard.
Forever.
Just move up the big guys.
Hey, I play Gideon.
Guys.
You have to attack
yeah,
him
sure.
next turn.
Move
like,
yeah, just move up
there.
I like Indomitable Angel.
Yeah, man.
Oh yeah,
your favorite
one spot
next to a
I mean,
it's like what was it like an 8/8 artifact angel?
Yeah,
as long as it's in play.
Or move the big guy
around.
Yeah, man.
Yeah,
we
can move the big guy one space, but I don't think that's good either because they're
flying.
I'll just move these
just
further up. Either way.
This game's gonna last forever.
Yeah.
Either one of those is fine.
No, they find a way around.
The woods is probably better.
There's a card that
says if these guys move, they should probably just move them to the woods.
It's a creature.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's like a big demon.
What's that card that just restarts the game?
Oh, card
movement.
Yeah,
card restart game.
Are you doing something about movement or anything?
Oh yeah.
Card.
This one after.
Is
everything done with your movement?
We haven't moved yet at
oh.
all. We just ordered everybody. This
oh.
is the start of the movement phase.
Yes.
He probably has something going to
just pull his card out of his pocket though.
So these guys move to here.
Yeah.
These guys move up here.
Man,
you're technically under control of those guys.
Yes.
These
guys, vengeance is
going
to
be
mine.
One, they play to get four
and
people.
Then they can move an extra space if they end adjacent to an enemy.
Oh,
so
Jesus. Fat ass are in the way.
I probably should have healed these guys.
By four.
Yeah. No, that's alright.
By four.
This is Adric command, so I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Cool. I'm going to spend 2 lore.
Is that really Y4?
I can remove a figure from a friendly place and then recover 1 health
Y4.
At another one. So we're going to remove one of these guys to put this guy back on the board.
That's cheating.
It is cheating. It was fun, though.
4 dudes?
I also get to one of these guys. They're going to move one space to here.
You can just let...
Win 4! Win 4 happen?
Over here or over here?
Huh?
It's
a little cheap.
Oh, they can move all the way over there.
Yeah,
1, 2, 3. No, probably the side would be better. Yeah.
Hey, there's the...
What happened?
Nothing. I'm just...
So the first...
Just touching
attack,
all your stuff.
First attack to attack.
Making
right?
it better.
Deleting the stream so nobody knows
first
what
first attack
to
attack you want. Because they kill them all.
Just knocks computer
over.
They can't retreat, but then the other one, they'll be weakened. And if they still survive, then they get pushed off.
I guess you're right, because either way, if we kill them, we're pretty good. And they're only going to kick their attack back with 2 dots, so they can't kill us. So even if they get hits, they can't kill us.
There you go.
Okay.
Cool. We're moving into the attack step.
Alright, so I'm gonna spend 9 points.
Are you serious?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Low in the load.
That's actually just 5.
Okay, so I was like, what is he playing?
And now we switch sides.
Exchange victory points.
45 minutes later, how did we lose?
Man, we're bad at
taking this shit, right?
Each friendly unit ignores 1 point of damage and 1 retreat each combat turn.
Mm, that's really good.
So,
first,
really
first damage.
That was the thing we needed to play two turns ago.
Shut
when
up.
Half of this army got wiped.
Shut up. It's better now.
No, it's not.
No, it's okay. It's fine. We're still going to have 4 points at the end of this, so.
Yup.
Who should we attack with first over there, though?
Let my guys attack here and kill that mage.
Yeah, yeah.
No.
That's what
we're
doing.
Dodge
it,
mage.
We're just going to always go across the board like this.
No.
All right, so these are berserkers.
Yeah.
Two dice.
Oh, no, we could do an arrow.
To retreat this one.
So they those mages just run?
Yeah.
Those mages just
yeah.
run like
but then they can they counter,
you play this
throw
and then
counter attack though. But no, it's over.
No, no,
nine.
They have to run.
Yeah.
So these guys
but
run
can
back.
They because of the bug?
Yeah, yeah. That's not that's
non,
the movement step.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Punish movement step, so
yeah.
So but
they
ignores,
move back here and
they
can't
the
move.
Oh
they
ignore
spikes
you, I don't
yeah,
want
anything
that.
Does with the
oh yeah, ignores one.
But they can't go over the mountain.
They could advance
that's
if you wanted
to,
but I don't know. Because they would then be able to counter back.
We're good.
I mean, could advance.
Yeah, we can stay beside
I can
this,
counter so. Punches with my mage. The one mage is like, come on, guys, fight me.
The one mage that killed my blood mages.
Okay,
blood
and here we're not going to attack those guys, right? Because we don't want to retreat.
Nothing.
Here, which
cats.
Side do we do fat?
They're not cats, they're hellhounds, guys. They're like flesh replacements. Look at this guy.
Wingless griffin.
So mad.
It kind of looks like...
That's how I feel when...
That's not
like
a cat.
It looks more like a bird.
That's what I feel
right
there.
That Buffalo Wild Wings commercial?
Does it look like a cat to you?
It shows like...
It looks more canine than freaking cat.
I don't know.
It's
the guys with the robes off that are...
Let's see what happens here.
So you're attacking with the doggy dogs.
That gas stands up.
No.
Like a black boat.
So we're going to attack dogs first, then we're going to attack them. If either side kills them, which
you
guys are not going to be able to kill them.
There's a knock on them, though.
That's fine.
Hello.
So he doesn't care.
What do you mean it's fine? Where is the second knock on them?
There's more knife. It's on the roof now. It's inside the room.
That's,
so the question
that's zero hits, right?
Yes.
I parked
survived. Survived.
Because they
oh, wait,
reduce the damage
oh,
by
yeah.
one.
Okay.
But that's the first damage during the turn.
What did it say?
Wait.
Right? What does the card say?
It said, you know, the first
each combat this turn.
Each combat?
Yes.
Yeah.
Each
okay,
combat. So that'll be each combat.
Woo!
Okay. So we might not win this turn.
That's all right. We need to hold one of these after this.
You're right.
But my bug probably dies.
Oh,
I don't think your bug's going to die. Those guys are all weakened all right. over there.
Yeah,
no. There's
it's
no
not,
way.
It's not.
All right, right. Let's go for the win. Two retreats or two... Yeah, two retreats.
Two retreats is better than anything.
Yeah. Two retreats is all we need.
Two retreats, yeah.
Will these guys do anything else with their...
Not now. They don't have any special things on this.
Or three kills. Or four kills, I mean. Two retreats or four kills.
They're good. They're good if they try to attack
more.
Us. But
I could
yeah.
do the thing I wanted to do before. But we would have lost it.
Yeah. You stink.
That's
two
attacks.
See,
two.
That card would have been super hard right. if AJ had any of those. Because we
well,
could have just been
they're
like,
still all
spirit
up
bomb.
They're not going to be able to kill all that stuff off of there.
You guys got
oh,
counter
yeah.
attack?
And these guys, who are they going to attack?
No, we're going
to
do the
oh,
best.
Oh, wait, do we get to a counter attack?
Yeah, counter attack.
Oh, you do get
we'll do the best I can. Unless you want to do it. It's on your side, man.
Yeah, let me do that. You haven't been doing that good.
Hey, whatever.
Yeah, blaming you for...
Blame me for a dice game. Oh, look, you suck as well.
Oh, wait. Hey, that's a retreat?
That's a damage
yeah.
and a retreat.
Oh, it is.
But
it
does
is a damage and a retreat.
Oh, wait. Because we're not... Because we're melee right now.
And the thing is,
who's
you can't retreat, so it's two damage, right?
That attack
you're right.
Ha! Two damage?
Yes.
Boom, baby!
I'm glad that a human.
Oh, wait,
though.
We hit their
fast?
Yeah,
we did it!
Okay.
Wait. During your opponent's attack step? Wait,
yeah.
Never mind, that's not
yeah!
Yeah.
Okay.
Hector's like,
yeah.
oh, that thing that makes us win, yeah.
No, it doesn't actually. Right. It's during your attack step, not our attack step.
In there.
Because it allows us to a counter if you were making us retreat. But that's we don't get to counter after we just attack
okay.
you.
We'll play the card of randomness.
I guess we will get 4 points then instead of
six.
It would have been 6 points. Because that's worth 2 points if you get there.
You can just get it.
There's no way we can't.
Well, it's... Nope.
There's no way to get it before.
Nope.
All right,
nope.
So we just need to hold one position.
So you know what you should have done,
yep.
right? Is, not really just
or be on
oh, wait,
take one
so
back.
So we get to draw a card.
You should have drawn those two cards. You just only won one.
Yeah.
We get to draw a card.
Just got one. Yeah.
What?
We get to draw one of these.
That's okay.
We'll make do with our loss.
That's why I was saying hang on with the archers.
We'll just play again.
Because that's the only card you can play.
But,
yeah.
And then I think we just do one and one. Just to see if we get something random. Why would we not do one and one? We only have one card.
Yeah, okay.
You're
right.
Did you know?
Because it doesn't matter, because we have to do
one.
But
in Vanguard,
we
if you call a final turn and you don't get it, you just lose.
Yeah, but I mean, if we roll a whole bunch of lore on our attacks or on our defenses, we could be able to play the cards.
How do we lose?
How do we do that?
Odoke, your command.
How?
Command.
Assuming that these...
I don't even know.
Nothing.
I don't even know what to do.
They make you pay for your hubris.
What if we did...
Well, that's fine.
Final turn.
What do we need to do?
Take over every spot and hold them another round.
Honestly, what we need is all of those cards really picked up from the middle that gives everybody movement.
You can discard these probably.
Yes.
Yeah, unless you want one of those.
Yeah, no, we don't want one of those.
Yeah, when you do counterattack, it only copies one of
those
cards. Which is actually...
What happened to... How did you...
All
of your guys go? They just like...
He didn't start with as many.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay.
That's the same thing
over
here.
I had five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh,
so
they got all the way over there. That's one I was...
Yeah.
It's like... Okay.
Where have my guys been systematically destroyed?
Yeah, his guys were a lot more expensive, I guess, than your guys were.
Take that spot.
For the most part.
It's not happening.
I mean, you can do it.
Well, actually, no, because of that special thing. So why don't we do...
You might be able to kill my bug, though.
This, right? So that'll give us five.
He has to ignore the bug to be able to try to keep us from winning.
Because
the bug is not standing on a victory point.
We got 14.
We
have 14 points.
Yeah, these things with the automation.
Are we still playing 4 people?
Or you could do this.
We're going to play
them. We should play
15. That would be
6. This needs to end. They're overrunning us.
Yeah, no matter what, we're
going to
get
you can do a reading, but we don't need to overkill it. You don't need to just like, all right, we'll just win when we route.
The problem
the
is,
you don't
it doesn't really matter because they're a
you
three.
Can just ignore this.
So like,
well,
if we went to 20,
because you have these here,
we would just be playing for longer.
So
they would just be killing
us. No, fuck that. No,
if we did
I mean, they could probably get up to 5 or 6 or 7.
I think 15 is the right number for this.
Yeah.
3.
I mean, even if it was close, I mean,
here's
if it was closer,
thing,
it'd be like...
Here's the thing, we have to take
if you guys had taken
four
a couple
of
these when we had shots on it, or like that one...
15 is how much you play in a two-player game with just half of this, but there's a lot more ways to get victory points. There's like a bunch of like weird special stuff. Normally you can get like 3 a turn. Well, this you get 4 a turn.
This should have really been like 7 to... 6 or 5, because they got really unlucky on some of the stuff over here.
No,
we just stayed on the points.
It was like I just stayed on the points. And then you have
hey!
Hi, buddy.
You look like you on.
What? Just a little bit.
What?
Ryan said you weren't coming.
I wasn't.
We're almost dead here. If they would pass, we'd win the game.
But
we win the game.
I mean, okay. Yeah, that's fine. Here's the thing, though.
So we're playing 15 points.
We
have 14. They have 3.
You have to spend the lore for me to get them.
I think it's still doing.
Yeah, right?
I still need.
I trust you.
Yeah, man.
You need. They have to get. They have to kill these guys. They have to kill these guys. They have to kill these guys. And they have to kill those.
They have to get.
Which they could do. They could do that. But the problem is, we're playing Battlelore.
Probably him.
But we're playing Epic Battlelore. So like. Me and Ryan are the Lord Commanders.
The best thing I can do is shoot with this. We give out commands to the people on both sides of us. But this guy hasn't hit a fucking.
That was your downfall.
All right, man, go with it. Whatever.
Typically,
coming after me.
Pick someone with the most experience. It didn't work out. Wait. So he said, like,
okay,
I
want
those
twice.
And
yeah,
then
5, 1
in
the middle, 2
in
the
middle.
I'm
going
to let you tell
these
guys.
These guys only have one
move.
That's
their special ability, man.
So these guys for sure.
I can spend one lore token.
It's like
a moment
version of football.
Okay.
You need the lore token?
Probably.
I did whatever you told me to.
During your order step, you may spend one lore to order this unit as if it were in any section. If you do... This unit may move one additional hex during the move step. I'm pretty sure you don't have to command it to do that.
Wait, what?
Huh?
Are you kidding me?
I'm pretty sure I'm not kidding you.
So half of the army over here could have been up,
but
that we just left.
They would have died over here somewhere.
Well, but they're actually good because they have armor, so they can just ignore damage.
But I mean, I wasn't paying attention to you guys.
But they only have
one. I've never played with any of those guys over here.
Yeah,
we read.
But you
guys
can move them, but you can't attack with them.
So he's saying he. To do this, we don't have to do this.
We can just be like spindle.
But you can't.
Like, I don't think you don't get to attack though, does it? Right?
No, you just move them.
You just move them,
which is fine, honestly, because we just needed support up there.
And you guys had like a
bunch of set in the original spots they've been
you
in.
You had like a bajillion lore.
Yeah,
that's why they only have one movement because you can spend lore to move them instead. Because they're like they're
guys,
automatons.
Right?
They're not
fight
actually people. They're like robots.
Now we know for next time.
Yeah.
Knowing
is
how maybe like 5% of this battle.
He's like deep inside. He was like,
I didn't think about it all until he said these guys, and I was like, what are those guys?
Yeah.
Sure.
I can't play my entire opponent's thing for them.
Okay.
You can.
R T.
You guys ended up like building bridges.
We read it twice.
We started
some cards that show him what he's supposed
okay.
to
do. Okay, we got all our shit.
So yeah, one side is the bridge.
There's
You guys doing anything?
Yeah,
after
you have
the
to stop on the floors, but the bridge you can't.
Okay. I think so.
Okay.
We're doing anything after
moving. After the order step.
Okay. Is anybody moving other than Eagle?
Wait.
Eagle.
It's after the move step.
He's done a whole lot of nothing because. He probably could
have
gone there and wrecked Eagle, but we didn't.
But the thing is, it'll double arrange it
again. So,
no.
But we need to take it.
No, because if you. Okay. We lose either way.
If we can at least take the spots.
For sure you lose.
How exactly are you taking this spot?
Yeah, that's right.
We're not.
We'll just do the fun thing.
It's not happening. We're not even going to take this spot.
We might be able to.
Take
this
it.
Thing,
so
this thing
moving,
hasn't hit a wall all game.
The funny thing would be if it killed all these off, and then that guy came up into the spot. And it wouldn't be able to attack.
No, I remember just one guy in it.
Right
to save that point.
No, man, we're going to fight the big guy.
That is stupid because he gets to counterattack you.
Whatever.
We lost.
Real thing, what's up?
It's the last round, right?
Yeah, it is.
Alright,
and then.
There's no way we'll be able to take all the points.
Blaze
of Gloria.
Yeah, man.
I'm gonna spend four.
Where's like
car
no man, lose harder.
Okay.
Yes. Are you gonna move automatons with your money? No.
You gotta spend
these.
It's too late.
Do something.
Our archers have enchanted arrows.
Oh yeah, that sucks. They can like shoot like anywhere on the board, basically.
range is doubled.
They can ignore.
Their line of sight isn't blocked by a terrain or units, and then damage can't be prevented.
I'm attacking the big guy.
That's the only archer.
Come on.
It's only archers. So those guys
are attacking the big guy.
Does it specifically say archers?
Yep.
Yes, just archers.
So
just
no
not casters.
Oh, just those guys.
Okay.
Which is why it's awful, because he has archers and I have casters, and so we've been drawing cards.
Do they get an extra die
like, this
or
is for
or
casters,
just
and that's for
anywhere.
Archers.
Like,
dude, attack the
no,
big
man.
Guy with
it's
your archers.
It's because how he set it up with, like,
oh, wait,
this being the expansion.
Eight?
So you mixed them, then.
Yeah, that
actually...
The big guy's going down. Not really.
I don't know. It's kind of hard to...
I mean, they can save.
Split it anyway.
Like, look, they kill these guys. These guys.
But then on your turn, you guys...
But y'all just move on to it.
Honestly, if you have, like, two powerhouses in the middle, you could just have all the cards together.
Oh, I don't have enough of that.
You have no.
Fire your ballista to the big guy over here.
Alright, so yeah.
You gonna play portals?
Ballistas have a range of 15.
Oh, yeah,
fire.
The portals card
is kind of
weird. Did you get that? The one that like lets you like teleport people across the board or something?
Yeah.
And Ryan's like, we can use this. I'm like, for what?
To just completely abandon.
We can only move one so you can be over there and watch our loss.
Yes.
What's he? See, he can't attack.
That's awesome.
Okay, movement. Did everybody move?
Yep, we're moving. I play my card after movement.
Alright, so what's attacking us? Big guy?
This thing. Attacking those three.
Watch
four.
It not hit a motherfucker.
If all three of them hit, then you can't even walk into the point.
He has four. Well,
these guys
come,
right? That guy moved.
No. He's already moved.
That's fine.
Yeah, he did.
So, your chance is this guy has to kill these guys so he can move on to the spot.
Advance, yeah.
I'm just saying it would be hilarious if you killed them, because then that guy wouldn't even be able to attack or move.
Whatever, this thing's not going to hit.
Just wreck him.
Nope.
Point in case.
You're correct.
That doesn't do anything.
Point in case, it does nothing.
Hey, you get a lore.
Get a lore, man. Generate lore.
You know what's great about this? This is, I'm pretty sure, exactly what I've rolled the past three times I've shot with this guy. And it does jack shit. It does nothing.
See, it's supposed to be one out of six, but you rolled it like 12, so you should have at least two hits.
At some point, yeah. I might have hit something one day. So this thing, but since it's... Do I still roll three since it's working?
Yes. You just have to get double.
I just have to get a double.
Generate more lore, man. Yeah!
Woo!
If I get enough larks,
the siege gauntlet might look cooler than it actually is.
And I get the berserker.
Wait, hang on, I do one damage.
Okay, so
for trample.
He said do.
Wait,
because it ignored the tree.
Huh?
Because this ignored the tree. So it does one
walk
damage.
Away from this.
Wait, I get two dice.
What does it say?
If a target unit is supported, calls one damage for each retreating
unit. Oh, gotcha.
Yeah.
Right,
so something happened.
Hey!
Woo!
Really?
Yes!
Well.
You got three lore.
Three lore.
How do you get to roll so many dice?
Because it was these guys, right?
So no, it's not that same.
Oh.
Mad cheats.
They get two dice.
It's okay. It's fine.
It's
okay.
It's these guys.
We'll take that.
They're those guys. Those
are
the berserkers.
Oh.
No, that's cool.
If you,
that's good.
So this guy.
How about nothing? We'll do nothing, man.
I
roll. I
was
going
to say, this guy can retreat and you can advance on them if you like.
No, we'll do nothing.
We're good.
I get nothing on that.
Pass.
Perfect. Whatever you guys are going to do. All
right, Ryan.
I mean, that's it. Yeah.
I'm
just trying to get vengeance.
Archers!
I need two dice.
You need
dos dices.
I need to
get to roll five
so,
dice.
So, where are the archers?
These guys first.
Is it too early to scoop our side of the board here?
Just listen.
He wants a victory picture.
So what did you roll?
Bananas? Sorry, ready to go.
Oh my god.
Did you fail?
No,
hey man, you get a lore.
I rolled a lore.
Hey, we got three lore, man.
You
hey.
Gotta attack twice, though.
Regenerated lore.
Okay.
Hey!
You ain't getting a lore.
Here?
Yeah.
This guy retreats.
Oh no. That's fine. I'm in range.
The eagle's not.
He's unit ignores any retreatment.
Oh no! That sucks. If he would have retreated,
he would
have been
okay. These archers. Alright. Wait, no, it's my turn, man.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
It's not you.
Oh, may we ignore.
What do you do with these things? What happened
here?
Oh,
I
want to
see him punch the eagle.
Why? Oh, yeah, he might want to punch the eagle back.
I hate you so much.
So, we're back to the man.
Hey, whatever.
Yeah, crime. That does nothing.
Is this your archer?
Who was that?
Yeah.
Oh, that big guy.
This is why you should shoot with the eagle first.
Oh, that was going to be one.
There's another retreat where he can run away.
Woo!
If does nothing.
Yeah.
Eagle time.
I handed this to archers.
I hope the eagle doesn't get two retreats, because then that will mean that we won't be able to attack him. Because we won't be able to ignore
him.
You
know, like, up five.
Oh, just
one.
One hit.
So damage, retreat, and bullshit.
Mobile!
Hey, look at all those targets over there.
What just happened?
Imagine if that was on that
or
side of the board.
Oh, God.
That was pretty awful. It's only when there's guys next to it, right?
Yeah.
Did any of the other stuff?
Dude, that
so
was
it's
a
like
great roll.
It's like it needs to be in
that,
the fight and shoot it at something far
real?
Away.
What's
it only
range?
Gets,
just one
hit. It's 2 to 6.
So
he
gets
no,
back.
Movement.
Movement's
sure.
1. So it's just like, hey,
four,
and then at that point you guys just surround it, and it's like,
well, yeah. And then
remember,
it's
can
almost
it can, but it's like
it's
it has
to like
be there.
Too slow to because you can't move and attack.
So you go back
right?
two spaces.
Yeah.
So
the best option is for him to open up a portal over here, and I go loop.
Yeah, that
would be two spaces. Yeah, in retreating in this game, you don't get to like choose where you go. It's always like directly away.
Now he gets to fly.
And now you get to fly.
Back to the Forest of Gandalf.
Alright.
So,
Scoop!
So,
Scoop,
can we just, like, not do anything for our turn?
Yeah, yeah man.
Because we don't even have to do anything for our turn.
Juju!
But we could take that.
I really want to just kill everything over here. Oh, I already have.
Look at happened.
Yeah.
So you spoke and so it happened.
Bug house.
Should have brought a new attack.
And
man,
the dice rolls for you guys are pretty.
We drew that rune.